Citrus Bowl in Orlando, Florida, where for the 22nd time, Florida A&M Rattlers and the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats will renew their series in the Florida Classic, brought to you by Walt Disney World Resorts. Hi, everyone, along with Mark Gray, Dwayne Ballin, welcome to Sunshine Network's coverage of this great event. For the fifth consecutive year, Mark, it will take place at this venue, and for the third time in four seasons, the road to the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference Championship stops here.
Well, a couple of teams came into this season thinking that they were going to be at this point in the season with a chance to win the championship, coming in after a couple of disappointing performances down the stretch, but the bottom line is each team with a win today can stake their claim to share the MEAC title.
Let's talk about two of the principals in this one. For Florida A&M, they call him the Mighty Quinn.
Well, Quinn Gray is a phenomenal offensive performer. He needs 19 yards to become the all-time total offense leader in FAMU history. He owns just about every offensive big-time arm, but where he's grown most is at 6'4", 230. He can run the offense now by using his leg. He gets it done by land and by air. A prolific passer who's become the ultimate field general. As Quinn Gray goes, so goes this Florida A&M post offense.
And his counterpart across the field, one of the most exciting at his position in the country.
Clearly, the most dominant offensive performer all around the MEAC is Alan Sumer, number one in total offense. Big-time arm, dangerous when he gets outside the pocket, and he also has 4-4 speed. As you can see, an accurate passer right there. He is the kind of player that can not only beat you on the ground, he can beat you in the air, and as Joe Taylor, the coach of Hampton, told us a couple of weeks ago, Dwayne, he is the perfect quarterback for the wide bone offense. Dollar for dollar, he is the best quarterback in college football in America that you never heard of. You're going to love watching Super Ball today.
Well, Bethune-Cookman has the number one ranked defense in the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference. Florida A&M, the number one ranked offense. So you have that proverbial irresistible force against the immovable object. Kickoff in the Florida Classic when we come back.
I'm Ruth Riley. My life revolves around sports. I love to watch sports, to play sports. My favorite movie is Hoosiers. It's not a choice. The best movie ever made. My mom means everything to me, and my family is all supportive of me along the way. I do try to answer all my family. If people take the time to write to me, that's the least I do is take the time to write them back.
For Miami Soul, it's call 786-777-4SOL or log on miamisoul.com.
The Ball. Resistance becomes strength, becomes power. The power to change and reshape your entire body. This is Bowflex, entire gym in one easy-to-use machine. So powerful, it delivers over 60 health club quality exercises with up to 410 pounds of resistance in any room in your home. Strength training with Bowflex is so effective that we guarantee you'll get the result you want in 6 weeks or less. One simple workout. 20 minutes a day, 3 days a week. Bowflex is real. The results are real. And own one with no money down and limits as low as $30 per month. Call right now for a free video and brochure. Bowflex, the power is yours.
This Tuesday, the Miami Dolphins take the field at Pro Players Stadium for their 0-2 debut. And you can be part of it free. It's Dolphin Night, a free evening of fun and games, including a special Dolphins night practice. Plus, select your seats. Get Dolphin season tickets to be part of all 10 exciting home games. Dolphin Night, August 6th from 5 to 9 p.m. at Pro Players Stadium. Dolphins football, we fight it. Call 1-888-FINSTICKS or visit MiamiDolphins.com.
Technology sure has changed since I was in school. Take the compact Presario 2813 notebook. Thin, light, powerful. With the Intel Pentium 4 processor, you get all that and the built-in networking to link students to campus. Plus, you can get a free carrying case and free multi-port so you can go wireless. All this for just $12.99 after $100 instant savings. Call 1-888-271-1826 now. Talk about lightening your course load.
Steak and Shake, we're a restaurant. You sit. I serve.
Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
All that trash in the paper. With Mike Wallace, Tony Moe. Olympic would be against Bethune-Cookman College. And oh Lord, if I 10-1, I win a national championship. If that one victory, one loss is against Bethune-Cookman College, thank you, Lord, but no thanks. I tell you what, you better have your boys ready.
Yesterday, Alvin White of Bethune-Cookman throwing down the gauntlet on behalf of his Wildcats against the Florida A&M Rattlers. We are underway. The 22nd renewal of the Florida Classic. Florida A&M winning the toss, electing to defer to the second half, and Bethune-Cookman will begin play to open up this game. Mark Gray, there is going to be tension on the field.
Well, it's healthy tension, and here's a kid that I think more than up to the challenge of handling it. Al Zuber came on the scene at North Carolina A&T during their homecoming last year, took over the reins of this offense. He has a swagger and a moxie about him. He is the perfect personality to run Alvin White's offense. You can say that he clearly is an extension in terms of the attitude and the character that he gives the Wildcat offense of Coach White.
5'10", 175-pound redshirt sophomore from nearby Tampa. First and 10 from the 20-yard line for Bethune-Cookman. The man in motion is Eric Lash. Silver, he's dangerous. He elects to run, but this time the Florida A&M defense, Jedrick Copeland leading the way, forces him out of bounds. Taking a look at Bethune-Cookman lineup that will be complimenting Silver this afternoon.
Well, Taji Parrish, the senior, is a really interesting factor, a Mr. Versatility kind of guy. Marcus Goggins is a key. Super says that if Goggins gets off, it makes the offense run a lot better. You see that guy in the middle, Darren Herndon, a legitimate NFL prospect. Makeshift offensive line, got some injuries, does Coach White. He has to pitch, pace, and hold a new O-line together.
Loss of three on the way, and this time Florida A&M defensive unit breakthrough with a sack. Joe Sanders dropping Super. Florida A&M defensive unit marked so far the first couple of plays. This group looks good.
Sean Kelly taking over for Nikhil Idem, an all-conference performer, but he's got nine sacks and 16 tackles for loss. They see Bynum now is going to play more of his role at the linebacker position. Watch him coming from the outside. That guy Copa figures to be a spot today. This is a very talented defensive backfield. Saquon Dow and Troy Hart, two of the better pilferers in terms of intercepting balls that this conference has to offer.
Impressive word, Mark. 3rd and 18. On the opening series, markers are down. There was movement along the interior line.
Had a conversation with Troy Hart yesterday after the luncheon where Coach Wyatt uttered those words that have certainly encouraged this Florida A&M team, Dwayne. And he said he thinks that his team will be able
delay
to get some pressure.
On the defense, the defender put in front of the offensive player, causing him to move.
They'll try to disrupt
third down.
That Bethune-Cookman offense by blitzing. Got to look at today's officials. This will be the final Midland Athletic Conference game for umpire Dwight Pettiford. And, of course, the keys to the game, as I said before, you got to get Marcus Goggins going. Bethune-Cookman has to focus on the fundamentals, make the catches, make the tackles, and stay disciplined. Don't let their emotions get the best of them.
3rd and 13 for Bethune-Cookman, opening drive of the game. And once again, Suber nearly put down. He gets away from tacklers, breaks upfield for a few, not too many, as he's scampering basically for his life on that play.
Tremendous defensive series, as you can see. They force him to stay in the pocket. Suber has ample time, great protection in the secondary. Neither he couldn't find Parrish or Lash, so he tucks it upfield. And they do a good job forcing him to the inside so that the support can come up from the safeties and the linebackers in the center of the field.
That brings on Danny Mathis to punt away on 4th down. And it rolls out of bounds at the 30-yard line, is where Bethune-Cookman downs it. That's where the A&M offense will take over. Now, you heard Alvin Wyatt when we began this telecast throwing down the gauntlet to Billy Joe of Florida A&M. Here was Coach Joe's response a few moments ago.
Yeah, it's no question about it. I feel very strongly about this game. This is our arch rival. We want to win this game. There's no question about it. And, you know, if Alvin Wyatt's going to take it over the top because we want to beat him badly, that's his problem. But he did take it over the top. He always takes it to the edge. But this past Friday, he took it over the top. It was too hard.
We can.
And if Florida A&M, with a chance to win the championship outright in the conference with a victory today, if they needed any more motivation, certainly Coach Alvin Wye did strike the coals. But again, it looks like we have another punt, Dwayne. Danny Mathis brought back out to for his toe to meet leather once again.
Mathis got this one away in the air. Levy Brown on the return. This is very good field position for A&M to begin. Another marker on the field, though.
I think we got a run the kicker penalty on Mathis, who is being helped off the field. So I wonder, does this cost Florida A&M football?
Danny Mathis, an important part.
Yeah, roughing the kicker on the defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
A call from referee Jerome Bogger. Danny Mathis is key to this team, such a consistent performer.
Yeah, the specialty units of these two teams figure not to be Achilles' heels. Florida A&M has struggled with the field goal kicking department. Mathis right there, clearly an upper echelon of punters in the MEAC. And a mental mistake now gives Alan Suber and his talented Bethune-Cookman offense a chance to crank it up one more time.
Keep your eyes on number 10 in the Bethune-Cookman offense, Taji Parrish, marketed earlier. This versatility can do so many things. First 10 at the 34-yard line. And they're trying to get going on the ground. Mark Goggins, 5'11", 212-pound junior on the carry.
And Goggins comes into this contest, Dwayne, averaging over 5 yards a carry. He's rushed for almost 600 yards. And when he's able to go off tackle like that, then that's going to make Suber that much more effective when he fakes that dive and try to get to the outside. If Goggins is having a big game, that's going to open up this wide going offense.
Pickup of 7 down to the 41-yard line for Bethune-Cookman. This time on the pitch, it's Eric Lash.
We see Dwayne, Florida A&M hit on the dive, and then Suber pulls it right out. And when you have success on the dive, you see, you've got linebackers like Alex Fortune that are going to bite on the inside, which allows Lash to come all the way around, get to the outside, and take the pitch, and pick up a big Rattler first down.
And that puts the Wildcats into Florida A&M territory. First down at the 47-yard line of the Rattlers. No score in the opening moments of the Florida Classic from the Florida Citrus Bowl in Orlando.
You know, we talked about these two teams, Dwayne, being wide open offenses, and they do like to get the ball down the field, and they move with quickness in terms of the no huddle and things of that nature. But this game will be defined by blood and guts between the tackles. The team whose offensive line can open up the holes. You have two undersized defenses that are going to have to rely on their quickness to go against massive offensive line. And the war in the trenches as this game plays out is going to be key to watch.
That 3-yard pickup to the 45-yard line. Suber looking to the air for the first time in this game. Has a receiver, and defensively, Saquon Dow was there.
Well, he's just a veteran who doesn't go for the dive and stays in beautiful coverage that time, running stride with the receiver. Watch the Brooklyn native just stride for stride with Darian Hubbard, and a great last-minute diving swat of the football by Dow, who traveled all the way from Brooklyn, New York, to play his college football in the love town of Tallahassee.
Brooklyn, New York native, has 3 interceptions this season, 5'10", 177 pounds. 3rd and 8 for Bethune-Cookman at the 45-yard line of Florida A&M. Suber again to the air, this time overthrows Hubbard.
And you know something, that's like Alan Suber is just a bit too pumped up right now.
Sorry, Hart defensively.
Yeah, he really didn't sit up in the pocket to get his feet planted under him, and that ball sailed on him. Nice route that time in the general direction of Hubbard, who had broken it off and squared out. But with the blitz coming up the middle, his pass goes around. Now, Levy Brown, one of the better kick return specialists in the conference, gets a second chance.
With Danny Mathis hurt, Zach Adrian comes on to punt. And we are not surprised that we see extracurricular activities. There's a lot of discussion heated at times between these two teams this week.
Boy, I tell you, you got to admire the nads of Shedrick Copeland. Boy, you ride somebody out of bounds on the opposition sideline in a heated rivalry contest like this, you are literally taking your life into your own hands.
The call from official referee Jerome Bogger. Personal foul.
After the play was over, personal foul on the defense. Half the distance to the line, first and 10.
So Florida A&M, when we return, will have an opportunity to get something going, albeit deep in their own territory. Tension's already up in the Florida Classic.
It's the Sunday night journey on Sunshine. Ease on in.
August 2nd on pay-per-view. More kicks, more punches, more mixed martial arts action. King of the Cage, Double Cross. Javier Showtime Vasquez puts it on the line. See the return of world champion Vernon Tiger White. That's Friday, August 2nd, live on pay-per-view. King of the Cage, Double Cross. Don't miss it.
Moving anytime soon? If so, remember to use Dish Mover, a service from Dish Network that makes your move easy. When you pack up, take your receiver with you and leave the dish behind. We'll take care of the rest. When you're moved into your new place, we'll deliver a new Dish 500 and install it. With one call, you'll be watching TV right away. Commit to 1 year of America's top 150 and sign up for credit card auto pay, and Dish Mover is free. Dish Mover is the easiest part of your move.
Getting enough ball? Good! Get in the game with all your favorite Florida teams at sunshinenetwork.com.
Back to the Florida Classic. Florida A&M picking up a first down rushing play from scrimmage by Kelsey Lordius. Lordius again gets the call, breaks into the secondary, where he's greeted quickly by Rasheen Mathis. Lordius off to a nice start.
Certainly right up the gut in the center of the Bethune-Cookman Wildcat defense. This is the number 8 defense in America, and they've been shredded on the last couple of run plays.
This no-huddle offense working quickly on first down. Quentin Gray has been wide open over the sidelines. Just overthrew Marco Julius.
Boy, that's what Quinn's got to wish he had back. You had 2 successful run plays to set up the play action, and Gray has his receiver Junius out there in the seam. Tries to thread the needle, and it's just over the outstretched arms of Junius. Oh, my. Watch that one. If they have success running the football in the middle, that'll be there all afternoon.
On second and 10, it's Lordius, where he's met by 5 maroon and white jerseys. Lordius along the offensive lineman that will support Gray.
March Banks is going to be a big factor at his halfback position. Charlie Allen, great possession receiver. Big Nasty's up front. Johnson, Logan McCullough, and Williams. Logan, one of the best in the MEAC.
Third down from the 36. Florida A&M, no score in the Florida Classic from Orlando, Florida. Quinn Gray out of the shotgun. Has Charles Allen enough for a first down? Great catch. Rasheen Mathis defensively.
Well, big time stick that time, and great concentration by Allen, the consummate possession receiver.
The men defending for Bethune-Cookman, Mark Gray, who stands out?
Well, Steve Baggs led the team with 9 sacks this season. Taking a look at the linebackers, Bubba Hubbard, a conference caliber performer and a solid NFL prospect. Mathis and Torrell Robinson, great safety.
On first down, Quinn Gray throws it away, and it's intercepted. Rasheen Mathis, the All-America.
Well, Mathis just makes big plays, in particular in the Florida Classic. Last year, he had a winning 2-yard return of his field goal for a touchdown. And here, a big break. He's out there playing center field. Great concentration by Mathis. Watch him to zero in. Look at his footwork. Ah, did he get both feet inbounds? Did he even get one inbounds, Dwayne?
Well, in college, you only need one, my friend. Mathis now has 4 interceptions to lead the Wildcats.
I'm anxious to see whether he got both feet after this play.
First and 10, ball at the 28 for Bethune-Cookman. Schuber did not fool Henry Vaughn.
Well, let's check out this interception one more time. You only need one foot in the ground in college football. And you see, it was the first foot that planted. The second one, he hauled it in, had Cole. It is indeed an interception. So great job by Rasheem Mathis, who trailed only his head football coach at Bethune-Cookman Wildcats in terms of number of career interceptions.
That's right. Mr. White, also an All-America defensive back, graduated from Bethune-Cookman in 1970. His Wildcats have the ball, second and 17 from the 21-yard line. The ball is on the ground and loose. It appears that Bethune-Cookman has recovered.
Boy, super over the last 3 weeks or so, has really been struggling in terms of protection of the football. Fake, he and Goggins once again. See, it's the fake dive that he's having problems pulling it away from. Sometimes I think even faking Goggins out. It was a situation in Daytona a couple of weeks ago during the MEAC broadcast where we saw Suber and Goggins kind of fumble the football at the end of the game at the 5-yard line, and it cost them a chance to be playing for the championship outright in today's game.
So Suber facing third and 19, operating out of the shotgun from the 19-yard line. Receiver had it for a moment, but was well covered.
Well, this secondary.
Levy Brown.
Levy Brown, Sequan, Troy Hart, they've got their game faces on, and they're on early. Blank coverage that time. Super getting great protection from his big nasty up front. It's just that the secondary has the Bethune-Cookman Wildcat receivers on the proverbial lockdown right now.
So Zach Adrian still on punting. Brown back to receive and is nailed the moment he catches the ball.
And you know something, there's a flag down, and I think they might have violated that cone. You're supposed to give the receiver at least 2 yards to field a punt. And I think that Bethune-Cookman was just a shade overzealous that time in their punt coverage.
That is the preliminary announcement by Jerome Boger. We'll hear from him officially in a moment. Alvin Wyatt, not at all happy with that.
Coach Wyatt.
We have run it into the 2 yards on the kicking team. 5-yard penalty, first and 10.
Well, let's watch the penalty right here. You see, he lost his footing, and the momentum carries him into the receiver. But you got to give him that 2 yards.
You know, that was a pretty gutsy play by Brown, considering three players are pairing down.
Boy, taking your life in your own hand, but it's a rivalry game. You know, from Clemson, South Carolina, North Carolina, North Carolina State, it goes.
So both the 46-yard line on first down. Florida A&M, Mark, are you surprised at the number of flags we've seen early, or is it a byproduct of this series and the tension in the rivalry?
That and the fact that a team like Florida A&M had a week off. They're kind of shaking off the rust right now. They haven't played since a heartbreaking overtime loss to Southern a couple of weeks ago. They're sort of getting their game legs back under them right now.
Second and 7 from their own 49 for the Rattlers. Quinn Gray with March back and Lordius behind him in the backfield. It's Lordius, and he goes nowhere.
You know why?
Alex Goins was there. That's why, number 18.
He does a great job reading that, forcing the play back to the inside, and then making a one-on-one play. That's just solid individual effort by Alex Goins.
Goins, 5'9", 175-pound senior from Rockledge, Florida. 35 from the 49. Out of the shotgun now for Gray. Scoreless in the first quarter. High snap. Shovel pass to Lordius. That's a first down. And more. Kenny Heatley may very well have saved a touchdown run by a determined Kelsey Lordius.
Boy, this is just a great play call. Billy Jump going with the fake option. Look, shovel pass right underneath in the center of the field. They get trap blocked, which, and the hole opens up. And then afterwards, March makes his legs in perpetual motion as he picked up the first down.
Marchbanks on the carry, stopped by Steve Baggs. Florida A&M has been driving consistently and well in this on this drive, moving the ball quite well on the ground. They continue to do so. Lordius simply will not go down.
Well, I'm going to tell you something. They found something soft in the middle there between Isaiah Smith and Alex Saunders up front for Bethune-Cookman, running a little trap. Either Jones and McCullough to the right or Jones and Terry Long to the left. The backs are having a lot of success.
On third down, Lordius appears to pick up another first down as he drags Jimmy Williams with him. Lordius, folks, this is a low center of gravity, 5'9", 209-pound senior from Miami. Hard to bring down.
And as you can see, Florida A&M forcing Bethune-Cookman to make defensive adjustments on the fly with the no-huddle offense, forcing him to play space.
First down. Guess who? This time, Aaron Shepherd was tracking him. Some keys to the game for Florida A&M, Coach Gray.
Well, we think that they've got to establish the run. Marchbanks and Lloyd must move the chains. Also, they've got to drop the drop. Wide receivers have to do a better job of holding on to Quinn Grain's passes and break the tone of the offense.
Whistles on the field.
That break the bone was in reference to the Rattler D.
We have timeout, White. It's their first charge timeout.
And the defensive assignments of Florida A&M against the Wyatt bone. They've got to stay at home and disrupt the flow of Wyatt's offense.
Kelvin Wyatt trying to figure out if he can stop Florida A&M from scoring. More after this.
Hey, hockey fans, it's time to get off the bench and pack the palace with 10-packs starting at just $99. With three new 10-packs to choose from, there's a plan for every fan. Pick 10 weekday games, 10 weekend games, or the Bacon Pack featuring 10 of the most popular games. Here's your chance to pack the palace with 10-packs starting at just $99. You'll want to be there to turn on All-Star goalie Nikolai Hobby-Bullen and your Tampa Bay Lightning. Call 813-301-6600.
Fishing then? Fishing now. As the needs of the avid angler have changed, so has Fluger, the legendary tackle manufacturer. Fluger is setting a new standard in quality performance with the Tryon series, Tryon Speed Reels, Tryon Bait Cast Reels, and Tryon Graphite Rods. Fishing has changed, but you can still rely on Fluger, a fishing tradition for over 120 years. Isn't it time you experience the legendary feel of a Fluger?
Great wheels, styling, and sound at a great price. Performing at your Dodge dealer.
Hey, I got any kumquats? I love kumquats.
I don't know what kumquats look like. They got some looking tomatoes. Do we need tomatoes?
No, I just got tomatoes.
They got kiwis. They got some red things here.
Hey, aren't you that guy?
Oh, sorry, I'm not him. What about bananas?
I know
yeah,
you.
I get that
know
all
you.
The time. I'm sorry.
You're on television.
Well.
In commercials.
Hey, pal. I don't do commercials.
Sorry.
What do you say, hon? Is 5 minutes too many to ground, you know?
Sure. Our kids' meal comes with a prize. It's called a steak burger.
When you see a number in front of a burger at a fast food place, it means that they're supposed to sell it to you before the big hand hits that number. Or throw it away. So, depending on how closely they watch the clock, you either end up with your dinner or their garbage.
Steak Jake. Famous for steak burgers.
SunshineNetwork.com is your web source for all your favorite e-merchandise. Just log on and go to SunshineNetwork.com to find the fan shop, an internet superstore stocked with over 5,000 different products, including team gear from all your favorite Florida teams and more. One click of a mouse and voila, you sent the perfect gift to the doorstep of your favorite fan. This season, get a spirit and go get a team gear merchandise at SunshineNetwork.com, powered by Football Fanatics.
Back here in Orlando, the Florida Classic presented by Walt Disney World Resorts, scoreless with 5-11 to go in the first quarter, but Florida A&M has given the ball quite well in this series and is very close. Second and 9, ball on the 16th. Lots of folks made their way to the Bowl for this one. 72,000 on hand.
Well, the success of Florida A&M, namely Kelsey Lordius with 37 yards, basically up the gut. They have been able to move the chains effectively and haven't really gone to the air as of yet.
Quinn Gray out of the shotgun. O.J. Marchbanks is one setback. Gray now moves above center. Pitches back to Marchbanks, who just wrestled down by Bubba Hubbard.
Yeah, but you got to give an assist that time to number 52, Steve Baggs, the defensive end who leads the team in sacks. He's real aggressive at putting pressure on quarterback, but that time he stayed at home, forced Gray to make a pitch later than he wanted to. and that strung the play out and allowed Hubbard to make the tackle.
Third and seven for the 14. Gray once again from the shotgun with March Banks as the setback. Three receivers on the near side. Here comes pressure. He gets off. That was nearly intercepted.
And that was also nearly pass interference as well.
Kenny Heatley had lead on that one.
And I think he made a run into the receiver first. Look at him. A delayed blitz. Pressure that time coming from the outside. Heatley just a little early there. But Jimmy Williams, the linebacker, forced Gray out of his comfort zone. He makes a good play on the block. Now, Juan Vasquez has been struggling all season, kicking field goals. It's on to try to give the Rattlers an early lead.
This is the young man that last year kicked a 34-yarder to give Florida A&M a 31-28 victory. Now he comes on to try and put the 3 points on the board of the game. And he does so with 4:18 to go. Juan Vasquez puts Florida A&M up 3-0.
Sunshine Network Live. It's the pregame to the night in four sports.
We'll take you to the sideline.
We'll take you inside the huddle.
It's the first place you'll see it or hear it. Sunshine Network Live.
Weeknights at 6:30.
If you love pro basketball, your season never ends. The Miracle hosts the Fort Fire Sunday night at 7:30 as we celebrate National Kids Day. Lower bowls get started at $8. Call 877-WNBA-6.
Don't let those lost weekenders get you down when your weekend is all said and done. What you really need is a little Sunday night journey. We'll lure you to a solid block of outdoor programming with tips from some of the best experts on hunting and fishing. So kick back, get comfortable, and ease on in for a Sunday night journey on Sunshine.
Monday at 7 on Sunshine.
Back at the Citrus Bowl in Orlando, Florida, Mark Gray and Dwayne Ballin here. For the fifth consecutive year, this game is being played at the site. 72,000 have come through the turnstiles here. One of the biggest games in the country. Some big-hearted fans.
Yes, it is. It's a venue that's been quite kind. Teams that have that call the MEAC home. You know, Florida A&M and Bethune-Cookman now playing here annually. Back during the 60s. Morgan State University won the Tangerine Bowl, which is now back on December 20th here.
Florida A&M leads the all-time series 42-11-1. Bethune-Cookman now on the kickoff. Norman Graham. Tackled by Johnny Todd at about the 27-yard line.
Well, let's see if the adjustment that Bethune-Cookman's offensive coordinators are making Brad Bernard is, are going to work. And as you can see, it's the 55th meeting of these two teams. Last time, last year, they met a real classic three-point victory for the Rattlers.
And Bethune-Cookman comes out trying to go wide. Saquon Dow was there.
Boy, he's just quick all over the place. I mean, to me, I've said it all season, Wayne. You're trying to get outside, you're playing to the strength of the Florida A&M defensive unit. They are so fast.
Well, Bethune-Cookman, not everyone on the same page on that play.
Illegal motion on the offense. All the offensive players were not set for 1 second before snap. 5-yard penalty. Replay first down.
Alvin White coming in disappointed because of some losses over the last few weeks. At one point, the Wildcats were in that driver's seat in the conference.
They certainly were until the homecoming slip-up against Carolina A&T. And then they came out flat, compounding slip-up against Hampton the following week. And they're battling for their championship lives right now.
And they open up first and 15 after the penalty. And Goggins slips up. Kelly is there.
And there's Alan Tuber, who's struggled a little bit last week in the nation's capital against Howard University, a game that Bethune-Cookman trailed until the fourth quarter. But they were able to find some offensive rhythm in the final period.
Now, so far, we have not called the name of Taji Parrish, number 10 for Bethune-Cookman, essential to their success.
Indeed. Got to find a way of getting short passes. Force him to make FAMU perimeter defensive players make plays.
On second down, Subers rolling out, elects to run, and is out of bounds.
The key, if you talk to coaches throughout the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, to contend with Bethune-Cookman is playing disciplined football and forcing Alan Suber to stay in the middle of the field. Right now, when he gets outside, tries to make things happen outside the pocket, Florida A&M's defensive backs are doing a good job of blanketing any receiver in pass pattern right now. So when Suber gets outside the pocket, you see absolutely nothing.
Third and 10 for the 27-yard line for Bethune-Cookman, trailing 3-0.
Well, there's Parrish, and Parrish gives back the first down.
Levy Brown is there. Taji Parrish, the man we just spoke of a moment ago, the first time he's involved in the play for them to win, he has to have a major role.
But this is a great throw by Alan Suber. Look at that. That's that old sidearm Kent Tecumseh type submarine delivery, and it's a strike. And Taji Parrish takes the initial hit, tried to reverse his field and pick up a little extra yardage. It cost him the first down. So it'll be interesting to see what Coach Bernard and the rest of the offensive brain trust of the Wildcats can do.
Zach Adrian nearly had that punt blocked, managed to get away. Troy Hart nearly got it.
That's just a phenomenal play. Troy came on the blitz and was back in there to make a big block as he takes big props from Lynn Thompson, the athletic director and former great punter. Look at this move. Troy, you thought you had me? No. And as you can see, Hart lost his shoe. He came out of his shoe, getting back in there to put the pressure on Adrian, who does a marvelous escape back and gets a great punt.
The ball we put in 49-yard punt by Adrian, who's having 35.4. That gives Florida A&M the ball at the 24-yard line on first and 10. The Rattlers lead 3-0, courtesy of Juan Vasquez field goal on their last series. Quinn Gray operating out of the shotgun. O.J. Marchbanks gets the call and is gang tackled after a pickup a couple.
Well, Florida A&M, as far as the run game plays are concerned, the exact opposite right now, DB, of Bethune-Cookman. The Wildcats off the option have been faking dive, trying to get it to the outside. Florida A&M staying between the tackles and really taking a page out of opposing offenses playbooks against the BCC defense.
Inside of 2 minutes to go, Charles Allen falls in a pass that is very close to a first down for Florida A&M. Kenny Heatley defensively on the play.
You got to have confidence in the receiver for you to release that pass before he makes his break. And Quinn Gray releases this pass, a strike to Charles Allen, and picks up the first down.
And moves the ball to the 39-yard line, 1:38 to go. Florida A&M already leading 3-0, looking for more. Kelsey Lordius, who had a nice start with the carry of about three.
Boy, he went right to the inside. This one was designed to go off tackle. Marble Hubbard got pressure. Not before Lordius picks up about 3 or 4 yards. This Florida A&M offensive front, the big nasties in orange and green, are just dominating right now at the point of attack. Their O-line is having their way against BCC defensive front.
Pick up a 4, second and 6 for the Rattlers. We came into this one 6-1 in the conference, 6-3 overall. There are whistles on the field.
As you can see, it looked like in that set, the effectiveness of A&M up the middle.
Dead ball, 12 men in the field on the defense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Well, that's one way of trying to clamp down on the rushing of the opposition. The extra man.
A little extra help. But Coach Gray, seriously, now we've seen Coach White. He's very upset right now. And then a mistake like that, clearly a breakdown mentally. Someone made a mistake, 12 plays on the field.
It's emotion. Talk about discipline. Bethune just a little on edge.
On second down, the pitch gets away from Lordius, who alertly gets out of bounds with the ball.
Yeah, and FAMU that time ran into a defense looking option. Quinn Gray had to pitch that ball early once again, because I think that was Hubbard that jumped in there Now watch. He wants to go down a little bit farther, but Hubb dumps it right there, forces in the pitch, and the pitch goes awry. And fortunately for Lourdes, he was next to the sideline, and it doesn't cost him the possession.
Third and five, ball at the 44-yard line for Quinn Gray and the Florida A&M Rattlers. Inside a minute here to go on the Florida Classic, and he overthrows Marco Junius. Gray appears fancy throwing the ball.
Well, that's because you got Steve Betts in there bearing down on forcing him to release, taking away any lane for him to step up from the inside. He threw that pass away. So, just to see some Quinn Gray numbers to see if he clips the total offense mark.
He needed 19 total yards to pass Otman Sampson as Florida A&M's all-time total offensive leader coming into this fourth down. Coming away is T.J. Smith. It's Mathis on a return. There is a flag. So let's just wait and see what the infraction was. Flag back at the 5-yard line. Rasheen Mathis stutter stepping. Nice return down the sideline. But judging from that sight, it might be coming back.
Well, I think Saquon Dow got picked up with a block in the back. Yep, and that block in the back, BB, is what's going to spring Rasheen Mathis around the corner. Coming at you in luck, living color, right here, 41. And I think Kenny Heatley is the guilty party, getting caught right in the back, right in front
we
of the...
illegal block in the back by the return team. Half the distance to the goal line, first and 10.
Good try, but you just can't do that right in front of the back judge. And clearly, Bethune-Cookman is just off a little bit right now. Maybe they're too pumped after that very vociferous and enthusiastic performance by head coach Alvin White at yesterday's meeting. But they basically right now are out of sync.
Well, they have quite a task in front of them, trailing 3-0 with 19 seconds to go. They have the ball at their own 3-yard line. And they keep it on the ground. And Florida A&M's defensive unit is there.
Boy, I tell you, the big fellas up front for Florida A&M just aren't budging. Stephen Brown and John Edwards doing a good job sitting at home. And when they do their job on the inside, that opens up the linebackers like Bynum and Fortson to come up and shut down on a powerful running attack.
After one quarter of the Florida Classic, it's Florida A&M leading the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats 3-0. More from the Citrus Bowl. Will Alvin Wyatt and his Wildcats get it together in the second quarter? We'll find out when we come back.
Not getting enough auto racing? Get in the game with all your favorite Florida teams at sunshinenetwork.com.
And you've got college football covered? Think again. Now you can get up to 12 additional games each week with the ESPN Game Plan College Football Packet available on Dish On Demand pay-per-view. The best games, the major conferences, it's maximum college football. But you can't just tune in, you gotta order the ESPN Game Plan College Football Pay-Per-View Package. To order, call 1-877-DISH-PPV.
Dish Network is all about convenience, and that means you're built too. Try credit card auto pay. You can set up a credit card or debit card to pay your Dish Network bill automatically, and it's easy to sign up. Just check the auto payment box on the front of your bill and fill it back. Send it to us with your payment. And next month, your bill is paid on time without writing a check or hassling with stamps and late fees. It's credit card auto pay from Dish Network.
Monday at 7 on Sunshine.
Welcome back to the Citrus Bowl. That young lady very happy. One of the 72,000 plus on hand for the Florida Classic. We began the second quarter. Cookman deep in its own territory. Alan Suber, a dangerous quarterback in open field. And this is why.
Well, Dwayne, you asked where Taji Parrish was? Whoop, there he is. Alan Suber, a magician with the ball. I thought that Steve Brown had done a good job. Watch number 98 come up inside there and disrupt the initial hole. And then Suber doesn't protect the football. Sucking and Levy Brown in makes the last pitch. And then Parrish just an outstanding job of running. Watch the fake there. That sucks Stephen Brown out the inside. Levy Brown has a beat on Zuber, and he couldn't get to him before the pitch to Parrish, and a big first down for Bethune.
And that set a first down at the 39-yard line. Gave Brad Lee some room to run up the middle.
Brad Lee, an unheralded running back this season who they expect big things from in Daytona Beach over the next few seasons. Guy's been a little nicked up this year. Big time speed, powerful back between the tackles. They speak with glowing enthusiasm about his future in the BCC program.
6'2", 205-pound sophomore from Wildwood, Florida. Pickup of 7 for him. Second and 3. Super fakes and then pitches. It's Parrish this time. He had a bead on him. Troy Hart stayed with him.
On that case, on that particular play, you got to have Hart. And FAMU's defense has Hart. And that's just a brilliant play when you consider the illegal block. What a play by Troy Hart, stepping up, playing off his block, and making a beautiful one-on-one.
A&M came into this one 6-1 overall.
Illegal block in the back by the offense. 5-yard penalty. Replay second down.
First quarter statistics. Coach Gray, which one jumps out at you the most?
Well, you mean to tell me that Florida A&M, a solid defense they are, held a wide bone to 28 yards in the quarter? That one really sticks out in my mind. I mean, and I'm also shocked that Florida A&M is leading. I mean, look at that disparity in rushing yards. 50-yard disparity, 68-18. Rattlers on the ground ahead of the Wildcats. And the bone part of the offense is normally stuck on the ground. And FAMU has gotten their offense going to the ground today.
Alan Super needs to answer some questions. He and the Wildcats trail the Rattlers 3-0.
Hey, hockey fans, it's time to get off the bench and pack the palace with 10-packs starting at just $99. With 3 new 10-packs to choose from, there's a plan for every fan. Pick 10 weekday games, 10 weekend games, or the big game pack featuring 10 of the most popular games. Here's your chance to pack the palace with 10-packs starting at just $99. You'll want to be there to cheer on All-Star goalie Nikolai Hobby-Bullen and your Tampa Bay Lightning. Call 813-301-6600.
The new Synergy Steel Reel. Stainless steel housing. Lightweight graphite frame. Oversized button for easy casting. Double padded handle, adjustable for left or right hand use. Dual pickup pins for dependable retrieve.
Dad, you accidentally picked up my reel again?
Sorry, I got it mixed up.
Synergy Steel from Shakespeare.
Putting
a new spin on spin casting.
SunshineNetwork.com is your web source for all your favorite team merchandise. Just log on and go to SunshineNetwork.com to find the fan shop, an internet superstore stocked with over 5,000 different products, including team gear from all your favorite Florida teams and more. One click of the mouse and voila, you've sent a perfect gift to the doorstep of your favorite fan. This season, get a spirit and go get them. Team gear merchandise at SunshineNetwork.com, powered by football fanatics.
Feel the rush. Feel the impact. Feel the power. It's in the attitude. The adrenaline rush. The opening punch. So get ready to rumble. Boxing on Sunshine. Are you feeling it? Striking up the best of the best. Bringing on a new sensation in boxing. And it's all right here. Boxing on Sunshine. Are you feeling it? Don't let those lost weekend blues get you down when your weekend is all said and done. What you really need is a little Sunday night journey. We'll lure you into a solid block of outdoor programming with tips from some of the best experts on hunting and fishing. So kick back, get comfortable, and ease on in for a Sunday night journey on Sunshine.
Getting enough basketball? Get in the game with all your favorite Florida teams at SunshineNetwork.com.
Now, your one only regional sports newscast, Inside Angle.
Who is the graduate brother most likely to pick up a hit?
Next up, Florida Sports News, weeknights at 10 on Sunshine Network.
These lovely ladies, part of the court for Bethune-Cookman. Big game, the Florida Classic on the Sunshine Network. Alvin Wyatt's Wildcats trail 3-0. Second and 8 for the 41. Alan Suber quarterbacking for the Wildcats. Under pressure, he gets away and has a receiver. Eric Lash, Carlos Moore was shadowing him defensively.
Well, Hart told me yesterday that Florida A&M felt confident they could disrupt the wide bone with blitzing. The linebackers of Florida A&M right now, Carlos Moore, getting him confused with the defensive coordinator, Carl Tunmore, but guys like he and Sanders and Fortson and Bynum are just blitzing with reckless abandon right now, and Bethune-Cookman hasn't figured it out yet.
No pickup on the play at all. Out of the shotgun now, Suber. Here come the Rattlers. Suber somehow gets away, still on his feet, and he's taken out of bounds.
Boy, the discipline and the aggressiveness, the effective discipline, aggressive discipline of Florida A&M has kept Suber in check right now. Watch right here is Chad Sessions. It's going to just zero in. Suber does a masterful job of escaping, looking like Harry Houdini, and he's thrown out of bounds there. But a tremendous job of downfield coverage by the FAMU defense, which allows their linebackers to come up and contain Al Suber. This is a beautiful performance at this point defensively by the Rattlers.
Once again, Zach Adrian is on the punt. This time, Levy Brown will allow it to bounce. And what a bounce it is for the Wildcats.
Well, I'll say it is.
Adrian, who had been the punter earlier this season, was actually benched because Coach Wyatt simply was not happy with his performance.
And Adrian's dad last year was the defensive coordinator until the week prior to the Florida Classic when he took the defensive coordinator position of the Chicago Enforcers of the now defunct XFL. So Coach Wyatt had to not only get the entire game plan together, call defensive signals last year for his Wildcats in this Classic.
That 52-yard punt by Adrian gives Florida A&M the ball at the 17-yard line. First and 10, Kelsey Lordius, who started off quite impressively in the first quarter, goes nowhere. Leading the way is William Hudson.
Well, Hudson just does a good job that time of holding his block at the line of scrimmage. I mean, he just stood Larry Ram up, and that allowed the linebackers to come over and for him to play off and make that play.
Hudson, 6'6", 230-pound redshirt freshman from Columbus, Georgia. Second and 5 at the 22-yard line. Check that, second and 10. Gray has a receiver. It's Marco Junius, who does a bit of dancing before he's taken down by Rasheen Mathis.
Boy, Mathis tried to induce a fumble that time. Almost. Well, I tell you, the secondaries of these two teams are in it right now, Dwayne. I mean, they are just getting after it. They're playing real aggressive. They're doing a good job of making the right reads in their zone areas. Nobody's over-pursuing, and they're just locking, loading on anybody in their area.
Has this number one ranked Wildcats defense settled down and showing itself in your opinion?
They certainly have. But again, Florida A&M, they clamped down on the running game in the middle. Now I think Gray has to make a play or two up top.
Third down, Gray out of the shotgun, needs one for a first down. Now he tries to escape the pressure and is wrapped up quickly.
Boy.
Aaron Shepard and Jimmy Williams combining on the tackle.
Boy, Jimmy Williams was just sort of lurking when Gray got around that corner. Stepped up in there to put the big lick on him. Gray wanted to go to something quick, and he looked one way. He's trying to quick out. Looked like he was looking in the direction of Isaac Brown. And look at Jimmy Williams just get out there showing his quicks to zero in on Quinn Gray and take him out.
That brings T.J. Smith came in averaging 39.6 yards per punt out of Columbia, Maryland. Rasheen Mathis will not get this one. It's out of bounds. So T.J. Smith makes sure that the All-America does not get the opportunity to electrify the fans.
Look what a little bit of Toyota clearance can get you.
A little bit of Forerunner. In my life,
a little bit of RAV4.
By my side.
Toyota's clearance means a lot of value on SUVs. Check out the powerful Sequoia, sophisticated Highlander, stylish RAV4, and adventurous 4Runner. And hurry in for 0.0% APR financing for 24 months or $1,250 cash back on every new 4Runner. Get Toyota's nationwide clearance going on now.
If you love pro basketball, your season never ends. The Miracles to Portland Fire, Sunday night, 7:30, as we break National Kids Day. Lower bowl tickets start at $8. Call 877-WNBA-6.
We don't doubt the billions. It's the search part we have trouble with.
Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
I think I've grown a second evil head.
Oh, I'm sorry. What if we go get refreshing Mike's hard iced tea? Would that help?
I didn't know Mike's made a hard iced tea.
You bet they do.
A hard day calls for a hard iced tea. They get Mike's.
Log on to sunshinenetwork.com to play Mercedes-Benz Hole-in-One Challenge. Take one swing on 9 different holes and see how close you can get to the pin. Win money if you stay in the fairway or make it on the green. And if you make a hole-in-one, it's worth $100,000. But watch out, no doper hazards. Stay out of the water, inbound, and off the beach. And you might find your name posted on the leaderboard. So log on and tee up in the Mercedes-Benz Hole-in-One Challenge.
Hudson, his defensive mates held. Now they turn it over to the offense. First down, and Suber goes down. Carlos Moore on a safety blitz.
That's right. He's coming right up there baited. They're just putting too many guys at the line of scrimmage right now. And one FAMU Rattler defensive player is down. Can't see his that. Don't say that. It looks like Alex Fort, number 5, one of those great linebackers, those extremely fast linebackers. For FAMU, who's down there laboring on the turf. He's a 6 foot, 225-pound junior out of Miami, part of that pipeline. 33 solo tackles and 7 sacks, and 54 total tackles this season. And if you've been with us during the course of the MEAC game of the week, we've seen him make big plays at critical times all season. But certainly, Dwayne, disrupt the momentum of the opposition in numerous games. In the Howard game, he had a big sack that led, big-time pressure that led to an interception. We saw him at Hampton. He was a dominating performer. He's a vital cog in this rap D.
We certainly do not want to speculate as to what the problem would be with him. But if he gets up and walks off the field under his own power, then that certainly is a positive sign.
And last,
take a look and see if we discern what happened to Fortson.
Let's see if we can get 5 coming in there. Lost his footing, so maybe it's a block. But as you can see, Florida A&M, that is, their defense right now, shooting the gap, and they're just loading the line of scrimmage. And the time has come for Bethune-Cookman to start thinking about some sort of misdirection and take advantage of the aggressiveness of the FAMU D. I mean, when they're committing blitz like that, a reverse or some kind of misdirection, as the defense vulnerable, it's taken Fortson a long period of time to get off the field, and that would be a devastating blow for the Rattler.
As Fortson limps off, Joe Sanders, a 6'245-pound junior, will replace him at number 40.
Fam had a big loss in the middle of their defense last year with Patrick Burrows, and when he went out, the run game became a lot more effective for Bethune-Cookman in this class.
Second and 16, 46-yard line for Al Super in the Wildcats. Lots of time to throw. Finally has a man open. Downfield. Touchdown, Wildcats.
You asked for Taji Parrish?
Taji Parrish.
You got Taji Parrish. Alan Super has all day to sit in the pocket and survey, take up some tailgate cuisine, make the right. for Parrish to come across the middle of the post. Look at the great protection up front. He looks one option, two options. Oh, there's Taji, my man, he's splitting him. He got behind Levy Brown, and Taji Parrish holds it in and takes it to the house. And Wildcat O seems to have found the beat.
And the extra point is added. The 54-yard connection between Alan Suber and Taji Parrish puts the Wildcats on top 7-3.
And we've been setting them up with the top plays up the middle. It brings people up towards the line, and Taji Parrish knows what to do with it when he gets behind the secondary.
Sunshine Network Live. It's the pregame to the night in Florida sports.
We'll take you to the sideline.
We'll take you inside the huddle.
It's the first place you'll see it or hear it. Sunshine Network Live.
Weeknight at 6:30.
Available now in this special television offer. The Sons of the Pioneers. The Sons of the Pioneers gives you two cassettes or two CDs with 42 of the greatest Western songs. The Sons of the Pioneers contains 42 Western greats, only $19.95 for cassettes or $24.95 for CDs. Here's how to order.
Call 800-992-5445 to order Sons of the Pioneers. Or send $19.95 for two cassettes or $20.95 for two CDs plus $25 shipping and handling to the address on your screen.
Monday at 7 on Sunshine.
Alan Suber connecting with Taji Parrish, the most dangerous man on the field for Bethune-Cookman.
Yeah, but it starts with the big SDs up front, giving him great protection, which allowed a long developing post. And he just split the team between Shedd Copeland and Levy Brown, got a step behind him. And there's Taji Parrish, a kid who was Mr. Everything last week against Howard University.
He played five positions in that win over Bison: running back, receiver, quarterback, punter, and in the fourth quarter, a little defensive back.
And for a senior playing in his last classic, how about making a name for yourself early on?
Isaac Brown on the return for Florida A&M gets up to the 13-yard line, and the Wildcats appear pumped up. Micah Simmons on the stop.
Well, this is a team in the Wildcats who's struggled with the demons of Florida Classic gone by, and they needed something positive to happen early on, especially the way they've been struggling offensively early in game over the last month of the season.
As the Florida A&M offensive unit comes out, Coach, let me ask you a question. We talked about the superlatives with Quinn Drake, but it bears noting he's thrown eight interceptions over the last seven quarters.
Yeah, there's been a lot of breakdowns in the offensive front, but, you know, many of those interceptions have come after they clutch passes that people have dropped. It's almost like in baseball, give a team an extra out. You give a defense an extra down, it leads to bad things.
In fact, he's thrown 13 interceptions this season, 14 now, counting Rasheen Mathis's earlier in the game.
There was no flag on the field
last year.
There was no
season.
12 men on the field.
He had a lot. Remember, there is no Jacque Nunnally. And with all due respect to this talented group of receivers that FAMU has this year, there are no Jacque Nunnally, Jesse Bendroses, or Kenan Lamb. We've seen a lot more passes go awry and go through hands than they've seen in a long time in Tallahassee this year.
So Alvin Wyatt's Wildcats, despite his lead, actually leads 7-3.
Against Bit, this is their first one.
Now see, now you got to get to that get back coach. You got that one coach runs around the sidelines telling everybody, get back, get back. Well, if you get a sideline warning, your get back coach ain't earning his meal money. So you know what happens when you go to the buffet after the game? You tell the get back coach, get back. Do your job.
Mark Gray coming to improv near you. First down 10 for Quinn Gray. Under pressure, gets it away, looking for Charles Allen.
Well, they did a good job, FAMU, that time, spreading the field, forcing Bethune into space. It opens up a wide area in the field. Watch the center of your screen. You're going to see Allen break right now, and he's got a step, and that pass is just over his outstretched arms. Defender was Micah Simmons.
On second down, loose on the ground.
Got the proverbial scrum going on right now, don't we? Only thing I'm missing in guys in bad yellow jackets and funny hats.
And it appears that Bethune-Cookman will retain possession.
A little bit of outside handoff work there to Kelsey Lordius, who has continued to go outside, and then a great job that time by Jimmy Williams, and that ball falls right in the hands. Couldn't see if it was Johnny on the spot to pick it off. Might have been Allen. Great job, Williams, getting that hand in there to trip it. Might have been Isaac Brown in there, bailing the Rattlers out.
So Florida A&M not only retains possession, but now has a first down. 9:13 to go. The Rattlers trail 7-3 in the Florida Classic from Orlando, Florida. Kelsey Lordius breaks up the middle, breaks outside. Battering ram hard to bring down.
Boy, this is right up the gut again. This is, you know, the Gulf Coast offense is supposed to be a finesse offense. Similar to the West Coast, this is smash mouth football. Watch Kenneth Jones, he's gonna pull there and take Bubba Hubbard out, and Glorious right there is gonna cut it right in behind him. And he becomes, as you said, Wayne, the battering ram down in the secondary, punishing defenders as they come up to try to tackle.
And Lordius's run sets up a first down at the 48-yard line. This time it's O.J. Marchbanks, the backfield mate, getting just across the 50-yard line.
Well, the heavyweight championship fight isn't until later on this evening, but this Florida A&M jabbing, and setting up something big. Soften the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats in the middle. That should open up a play-action pass here for them to go vertically sometime here shortly.
Second and 8, ball at midfield. Gray to Isaac Brown, who has it, and a first down.
Just a little bit of that pitch and catch. Quick slant patterns. Take advantage of the quickness off the line of scrimmage underneath the aggressive Bethune-Cookman Wildcat defenders. Brown finds the seam, picks up the first down.
So the Rattlers are on the move. 7:54 to go here from Orlando, Florida. O.J. Marchbanks stopped by Steve Banks. This running game, Florida A&M, is very impressive.
And when you're getting performances like you're getting from Terry Logan and Kenneth Jones, that's 51 and 74 are dominating at the point of attack.
Second and 4 from the 31, double reverse. It's DeMar Bowe, and he is nailed.
Hello.
By Toriel Robinson.
Boy, he just sized him up. Coming around, sometimes you don't go into Mr. Rob's neighborhood, and this is why. He's just going to play off a block. Quinn Gray got a nice block on Bubba Hubbard, but then Robinson just sized up Brown and cleaned his clock.
Third and 5 from the 32-yard line, Florida A&M. Quinn Gray out of the shotgun, under pressure, has a man. Isaac Brown. It's dearly courtesy of Sheen Mathis.
This is a great pass by Quinn Gray. I mean, this is a sidearm touch pass to a receiver in the flat, dropping it over a linebacker and right in front of a defensive back. Great pass by Quinn Gray. Mathis with the big-time stick, but not before a first down by the Rattlers, courtesy of Isaac Brown.
So it's first and 10 for Florida, and a ball at the 25-yard line of Bethune-Cookman, which leads 7-3, 6:20 to go here at the Citrus Bowl in the second quarter. Quinn Gray out of the shotgun, has a receiver across the middle. It's Chris Bonga.
Good hot read that time with the pressure coming from Bubba Hubbard. Hubbard gets pressure in there that time. And after the three-step drop, you got to look quickly at the hot receiver who was Bonga, who broke his pattern off and picked up another first down. This impressive drive by Quinn Gray, field generalship, in complete command of the Rattler offense.
Well, the senior from Fort Lauderdale now has his Rattlers at the 10-yard line. First down. Out of the gun once again, under pressure, has a receiver open, Bonga throws Isaac Brown.
Another good job on the hot read by Quinn Gray. I think he released that pass just a little bit too early because Jimmy Williams They come clean up the middle and watch the post pattern. You see, Oglesby can't get a hand on him, so he's going to break into the secondary and is wide open. Gray releases it early, and it's out of Brown's range.
Coach, you've mentioned a couple of times hybrid. Explain to our friends what that means.
That's when the blitz comes down in you, and you have to go to the hot receiver who's in the open area with no defenders around him.
On second and 10, Gray again looking to go to the air. This time, DeMar Bowe had it for a moment.
We've got a flag down in the secondary, but DeMar Bowe, indicative of the feet of Quinn Gray for most of the season. Receivers dropping passes. They are wide open. You know, if he catches that pass, he's still running. Takes it to the house.
Mark Gray, Dwayne Allen with you from Orlando, Florida. The Citrus Bowl, 72,000 on hand for the consecutive Florida Classic here at the Citrus Bowl, brought to you by the Walt Disney World Resort.
And this is a terrific event, as you can see. It stands to no other. I heard there may be actually closer to 80,000 people here. If you look at one of the ends of the end zone where they bring in the portable,
we have 12 men on the field participating in the play on the defense. Half the distance of the goal line, replay set down.
Well, once again, Bethune has 12 players on the field.
Boy, look at that crowd. That's just a beautiful look at one of the great events, not only in Black College football, but in sports right now. This game will outdraw some of the low-tiered major college bowl games this year, Dwayne.
They should be so lucky to have a crowd like this.
Yeah, I mean, like, you know, if the Micron PC had these numbers, it might still be the Micron PC Bowl.
Second down and three for Florida A&M, trailing some three. Quinn Gray, a keeper. Great defensive stop by Toy Robinson.
He's quick. I mean, that kid, they talk with reverence about him in Daytona Beach for being a pro. And watch him, not going to bite it. All he can do is make a lunge, grab the legs of the 230-pound quarterback, and bring him down. And Florida A&M's going to roll it. Well, it's third down.
Third down, O.J. March back into the end zone.
Boy, I tell you, March Banks will get the credit for the score. Kevin McCullough and Larry Ram off the right side of that fan view up at the front just crushed Bethune-Cookman, and he was able to basically waltz into the end zone.
After the touchdown, another celebration on the offense, 15-yard penalty. We do the trap.
And that's a penalty that's not a favorite of Coach Gray's.
No, it's not. Well, watch. Look at 71 right there. And Ram is already blocked down. And that's going to open up the hole for O.J. Banks to take it to the house. And now this is an interesting extra point attempt for Mr. Vasquez. It effectively becomes a 35-yard field goal. And as we've seen this season, Dwayne, he's like 2-for-10 in field goals coming into this contest. This by no means is automatic.
Well, his longest field goal of the season is 29 yards. So Vasquez on to make it 10-7. And he is off the mark.
Mark this, that's a big point in this contest right here.
So 9-7, Florida A&M runs into the end zone and into the lead. Just taken a 9-7 lead, but it could have been more, Mark.
You're absolutely right. Florida A&M really is fortunate that they had Vasquez botched two field goals last year. He botched an extra point in this particular situation, Dwayne. So that's a big point that's missing.
As Florida A&M gets set to kick off, we are pleased to have a special guest from the Walt Disney World Corporation. They are the sponsors, title sponsor of this event. Mark, a friend of ours.
That's right. Tom Flewellen of Walt Disney World is our guest here right now. And as soon as we watch this exciting kick, we'll talk in greater detail about Disney's role here in the Florida Classic. I mean, you're talking 5 years here, Tom, in Orlando, and another sellout. I mean, this is pretty big.
Oh, I tell you, we're so very proud to be part of this particular Classic. We believe that the best is yet to come. We have some plans for the future that's going to really take us over the top, far beyond any other Classic in the nation.
Now, I know there were some problems in Orlando, which led to the move. Excuse me, there were some problems in Tampa, which led to the move to Orlando. What did Orlando and Disney see in the Florida Classic that, frankly, Tampa missed out on?
Oh, we just saw an absolute an abundance of opportunity, an opportunity to partner with others within the community to bring the premier event here. And that premier event will raise in excess, like for example last year, raised in excess of $1 million to each school that helps with our future leaders of tomorrow. And we just all got together as a total collaborative effort to make this possible.
Tom, has Disney been surprised with the rapid growth of this event? It's really propelled itself into the forefront. Attendance?
No, not at all. We are absolutely thinking that it's right on the mark. In fact, we believe that there's more potential to even take this even further. Obviously, the only thing we're constrained about here is capacity.
Right.
It could go beyond that. But with the support of the mayor, the support of the Orange County government, with the support of other corporations and our Walt Disney World, we believe that this has the potential to be the best premier sporting event in the country.
Now, I'm going to put you on the spot now. Are there more Rattlers or more Wildcats?
There are only a few million people that are watching right now, so you shouldn't get yourself in much trouble.
No, I got to tell you something. I think it's 50-50.
Let's talk about now Disney really hasn't really gotten the props that it deserves for the involvement in minority events here. I remember back a few years ago, they were host for Miss Legion African American. You had the National Association of Black Journalists meeting here last summer. And now, this is, could you speak to the commitment minorities that Disney is making with this as the linchpin?
Oh, well, I think that obviously this tells everybody and really underscores our commitment to minorities throughout the country. But just the other, not too long ago, 3 weeks ago, we had the National Black MBAs. It was the largest black conference ever hosted by Walt Disney World here in Orlando. I think we had nearly 9,000 people in attendance. And that was followed by the African Americans in Human Resources. And then we just got through from hosting the Coalition of Black Meeting Planners. So I think our commitment here is just one more example to our community to say that Disney, we really, really care.
And sports has really become a big, big cog. You've got the Braves here now. You've got Disney's Wild World of Sports. And, of course, an event like this, and the Tangerine Bowl is coming back.
Oh, absolutely. And like I said, Mark, what we're looking forward to. Oh, look at this play here. Oh, what a pass.
That's Eric Lash.
Eric Lash.
Touchdown.
Touchdown. Bethune-Cookman. Eric Lash, the Wildcats strike big.
Boy, what a great pass by Alan Suber. He dropped it right over the linebacker, and once Lash broke the tackle, he was off to the races and takes it to the house. This is great pocket presence with the pitch bearing down. That's a great touch pass over Colvin, and it becomes a foot race at that point. And once he breaks that tackle right there, the quickness and speed of Lash, he outruns Troy Hart. And Bethune-Cookman with two big plays has seized control of this game.
The 6'1", 108-pound junior from Panama City goes 73 yards to give Bethune-Cookman the lead, and there are flags on the play on the extra point.
Wow, Tom, they got cranked up for you in the
booth. I got to tell you, that's why you asked, why are we involved in this? This is very exciting, and to be so close to our Walt Disney World, people have the opportunity to go and do a lot of things with me and all the other attractions that we have,
Clap
and then come
snap.
Out here and let this be the culminating event. It's all very exciting. We love this partnership.
Well, speaking of excitement, Dwayne, I'm trying to get into your back pocket for some excitement post-game this evening. So you've been anointed as our social liaison for the balance of the evening. Did you accept that challenge, of course?
You know, I've been offered a lot of challenges. That probably is the greatest challenge I have tonight.
Well, Thomas Llewellyn, we'd like to thank you for your corporation's involvement, and there are 80,000 or so people here that want to thank you, too.
Thank you very much, Dwayne. It was great to be here. And thanks for having me.
Thanks for spending
Keep
time
up
with
the
us.
Door.
Thank you, Mark. Thanks very much.
Thomas Llewellyn from the Walt Disney World Corporation, Walt Disney World Resort, is the title sponsor for this
Before
event.
Before the ball was out, we had 12 men on the field by defense. We'll penalize half the distance of the goal line, and we do the try.
Alvin White's Wildcats, courtesy a 74-yard strike from Alan Suber to Eric Lash, now lead 13-9. If Michael Kidd can be true, it will be 14-9. And so it is. So Eric Lash scored the second touchdown of his season on a big one.
Oh, hockey fans, it's time to get off the bench and pack a balance with 10 packs starting at just $99. With three new 10 packs to choose from, there's a prize for every fan. Pick 10 weekday games, 10 weekend games with a big game pack featuring 10 of the most popular games. Here's your chance to pack the balance with 10 packs starting at just $99. You want to be there to cheer on All-Star goalie Nikolai Hobby-Bolin and your Tampa Bay Lightning. Call 813-301-6600.
My stainless steel beauty. I shall call you Lucille.
What?
Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
You're watching Sunshine Network.
What you dream is possible. A world of easy communication. A real connection to deliver your message to whoever you wish. Virtually anywhere, anytime. Dish Network Business Solutions simplifies communication. Let the power of satellite link you with others via computer or television. Stay ahead of the pack and the sharks. You'll need to in today's changing world. Dish Network Business Solutions, clearly a better way to communicate.
Well, I'm here in the Virginia Beach oceanfront, soaking up some rays with Becky here. You having a good time, Becky?
Oh, yes, great beach.
Now, what if I show you a whole bunch of great things you could do besides sitting on the beach? Would you maybe want to come back a little sooner than next summer?
Sure.
Now, great. Well, if you call this number right here on the...
Where?
Excuse me?
What number?
What if I tell you that simply by calling this number on the screen...
What screen?
Where?
You see it, don't you? Call the number on the screen, they'll shoot right out to you.
Just tap this one?
All right, I'll call the number.
Back at the Citrus Bowl where Florida A&M finds itself 9-14, a happy group of Wildcat fans. And there, Bethune-Cookman Wildcats came back and struck big. Eric Lash from Alan Suber.
Yeah, we were wondering whether or not Bethune-Cookman was going to be able to jumpstart their offense. We thought they had to spread Florida A&M and try to attack deep. And they've been successful twice. Now, in a perfect world, if you're the offensive coordinator for Bethune, that should open up the inside for the run plays. Dives from Marcus Goggins, some of those option actions, or the trap plays up the middle for Taji Parrish could be there because Florida A&M will be respecting the fact that they outside skill players can get deep against them.
Michael Kidd is set to kick away. Florida A&M's Isaac Brown. Brown averaged 17.6 yards per return coming into this one. His longest 41 yards. And the senior from Baton Rouge will try to run it out. And he is met quickly. Josh Oglesby and Larry Creighton.
Boy, you talk about coming down there with some emotion inside in your pursuit. I thought for a second there Bethune-Cookman was going to, you know, get out of their lanes because of the emotion. But Craxton does a good job of cracking Isaac Brown.
So how now, with all due respect to Dr. Seuss, does Florida A&M respond here?
Quick passes, short stuff across the middle. They've got some things that they've been effective with in terms of running the football. Look at those numbers for Alan Suber. More economical with his success passing than Quinn Gray.
Gray came in with 18 touchdown passes on the season. Out of the shotgun, he's going long. And just beyond the outstretched body of Isaac Brown. Heatley defensively on the play.
Well, that's the difference, in my opinion, of Florida A&M this year and for perhaps the last 4 years. It's a situation where he gets great protection, lost a strike out there. The receiver normally can go out there and get, and Brown just can't haul it in. That's a great pass by Gray. He just doesn't have a receiver out there to go out there and get it that time. Just a little bit too far for the undersized Isaac Brown.
So it's second and 10. From the 16-yard line, Florida A&M Gray to the air again. Has O.J. Marchbanks out of the backfield. Josh Oglesby on the tackle.
Well, that's good safe stuff up underneath there. Just as effective as a run play. Clear out with your receivers. Let your back run underneath. And he's got a wide open center of the field in the hands.
And it also led to a first down. Gray staying in the air. This time it was nearly intercepted.
Boy, Oglesby wishes he had that one back. Boy, that one hit him right in the hands and went through his hands and hit him in the numbers, and he still couldn't haul it in. Great trying to go out here. Looked like he's going in the direction of Isaac Brown, and a good job in the two-deep zone of the underneath coverage, that being Oglesby, stepping in there and almost picking off the pass.
So it sets up second and 10. Still staying in the air, cannot connect. Oglesby again defensively on the play. DeMar Bowe trying to make exception.
Well, you know, a receiver's going to have to step up and make a play for Quinn Gray right now. Now, you've had two receivers get behind the Rattler secondary and make plays for Allen Suber. Now one of Quinn Gray's receivers has got to get behind the Wildcats secondary and make play for him.
It's third down and 10 for the Rattlers. Trail here at the Florida Classic, 14-9. Out of the shotgun is Gray. Time to throw. Releases to his back, O.J. Marchbanks, who was tripped up by Josh Oglesby, who is all over the field right now. Oglesby, 6'2", 230-pound junior from Daytona Beach.
Boy, that time there was a missed block, or this play is set up to perfection right up the middle. They got the delay. They had the screen set up, and I think that time Terry Logan might have missed the block, and that's why Oglesby is able to make that tackle.
Rasheen Mathis back at his own 17-yard line to receive T.J. Smith's punt. Last week, he returned one 73 yards for a touchdown and a victory over Howard. And he's off on the far sideline.
Well, that Saquon Dow can tackle, can he? Man, I mean, he's just all over the place, number 41 right there. Whether it's in pass coverage, as we saw him swat one earlier, or if he's coming up in run support or making special teams tackles, Saquon Dow gets it done.
Sports fans, tune in to Sunshine Network weeknights at 10 for Nextel Florida Sports News. Along with host Barry Milligan and Tom Locke, a lineup of reporters around the state will bring all the highlights, sound bites, interviews, and discussions right to you. Nextel Florida Sports News weeknights at 10, only on the Sunshine Network.
Well, here's a chance with Allen Suber and the Wildcat offense for them to go for the jugular here in the second quarter.
First down from the 39-yard line. Suber going in reverse for a while, then turns it back up. Will lose yardage on the play. Nakia Bynum on the tackle.
Man, I got to believe that there's some confusion in terms of the option and the dive. Now watch, you're going to see Florida A&M's defense. They're going to stay at home that time. Look at his play being strung to the outside by Dan Brown. And Suber just doesn't have a pitch man. And I just think that somebody, you know, maybe he and Goggins aren't on the same page of the book. I harken back to the Hampton game a few weeks ago here on Sunshine Network, Wayne, when you had a first goal situation at the three-yard line. We thought that the coaching staff had called a dive play, and there was a breakdown exchange. Well, Suber was supposed to fake the dive play. Goggins thought the play was going to him, and the breakdown in communication between those two led to a fumble, which cost them that game. I just think right now there's some confusion in the offensive backfield of Bethune-Cookman, and it's really thwarting the effectiveness of that wide bone right now, more so at this point in the game than any defensive adjustment that Florida A&M has made.
So Elvin Wyatt, the head coach of Bethune-Cookman College, 1970 graduate. This is his fifth season on the job at his alma mater. 34-19 record. Led Bethune-Cookman to a 9-2 record in 2000. Those of you watching us wondering what's happening down the road a bit, Miami leads Syracuse at the half, 24-0.
Big East is basketball, folks.
Send your letters and emails to Mark Gray. Second and 11 from the 38-yard line. Suber elects to keep it across the 45 before he's brought down by Shedrick Copeland.
And you know, if you want to follow up a point that you were making about Coach Alvin Wyatt, with all due respect, he is the most underpaid coach in the conference. I mean, every other assistant in the conference right now is making more than he does. We're talking about coordinators. Okay, offensive and defensive coordinators, certainly right across on the other side of the field, are making a lot more than Coach Wyatt. I mean, you got coordinators in this conference making in the high 90s, this coach making in the low 60s. You talk about dollar for dollar getting your money's worth.
Well, his Wildcats advance to a first down on the ground. Marcus Goggins with the pickup.
And you see they go off tackles to Goggins. Florida A&M getting a little bit softer right now. And we've noticed, Dwayne, in the games that we had them, the one in particular where they lost. And as you look at the half, we'll have the Battle of the Bands.
Timeout.
Featuring the marching Wildcats and Bethune-Cookman.
This is their third and final timeout.
A&M. But Dwayne, we've seen as games wear on, if you play physical Florida A&M early, they wear down just a little bit in fourth quarter. And they haven't been exactly a great comeback team as well. So things have fallen into place for Bethune-Cookman. You just wonder if they can take advantage of it.
The fraternity stepping that appeared to be the men of Omega Psi Phi.
I think that's fairly accurate.
Dr. Frederick Humphrey, the president of Florida A&M, folks. He has
That's Dr. Bronson, the president of
Bethune-Cookman.
Bethune-Cookman right next to him. And you talk about one of the guys who's done a marvelous job at running an institution.
Dr. Humphrey's friends on your right, for six out of the last 10 years, Florida A&M has led the nation in national merit scholars at any level. This year, they tied with Harvard University for the most. Now, national merit scholars means a 3.5 GPA or 1,200 on the SAT. And Dr. Humphreys has placed a major emphasis on academics at Florida A&M. Time Magazine has recognized it as the College of the Year, been written up in major periodicals everywhere. What a legacy he leaves as he exits Tallahassee.
You know, you talk about big shoes to fill. Those are some enormous shoes to fill in Tallahassee.
On first down, the Rattlers trying to stop the Wildcats, and they get him on the sack. Nakia Bynum, John Kelly.
Yeah, that's number 10 for Kelly, a freshman who just knows how to sack quarterback. This is a guy who's tied up. He's designed to stay at home. So why? Suber's going to look out there. And he's going to be like, if I can get around the corner past Kelly, I can still be running, and Kelly just ain't having it. Good job that time. Proverbial rodeo lasso of the quarterback by the freshman.
Kelly's 10th sack of the season. He leads the team in that category. 6'1", 218-pound freshman. Loss of 10, so second and 20. Nice coverage by Ricky Funches on Eric Lash.
Yeah, they're rotating a couple of people over in the direction of Lash right now as we close inside the last 15 seconds of the first half. I think that's probably going to be the last play of the half. So Suber's a little dejected that his team won't attack. But once again, Dwayne, as the case last year, Bethune-Cookman will lead at the half. They've been the dominant team in the first 30 minutes of the last two Florida Classics. But it's a 60-minute contest, and it'll be interesting to see if Bethune-Cookman can finish today.
What will Alvin White say to his Wildcats and Billy Joe to his Rattlers? They provided us with some thrills in the first half. It's Bethune-Cookman, 14, Florida A&M, 9. The Florida Classic is at the half.
Hey, hockey fans, it's time to get off the bench and pack the palace. With 10-packs starting at just $99. With 3 new 10-packs to choose from, there's a plan for every fan. 10 weekday games, 10 weekend games, or the big game pack featuring 10 of the most popular games. Here's your chance to pack the palace. With 10-packs starting at just $99. You'll want to be there to cheer on All-Star goalie Nikolai Hobby Bullet. If you're Tampa Bay Lightning, call 813-301-6600.
What a little bit of Toyota clearance can get you.
A little bit of
Tundra
in my life. A little bit of
Tacoma
by my side.
Toyota clearance means a lot of value on trucks. Get great deals on tough Toyota trucks like Tacoma. You can count on it to perform in any situation. Or the full-size Tundra. Get 0.0% APR financing for 24 months or $1,000 cash back on Tundra. Get to Toyota's nationwide clearance going on now.
At Steak and Shake, we're a restaurant. We take care of them. Steakers. They order them. He cooks them. And I serve them.
Steak and Shake.
I'm going to wrap up. That was going on.
Sunshine Network. Hammer down.
SunshineNetwork.com is your web source for all your favorite team merchandise. Just log on and go to SunshineNetwork.com to find a fan shop, an internet superstore stocked with over 5,000 different products, including team gear for all your favorite Florida teams and more. One click of the mouse and voila, you sent the perfect gift to the doorstep of your favorite fan. This season, get in the spirit and go get them. Team gear merchandise at SunshineNetwork.com, powered by Football Fanatics.
Let's look at some of the highlights from the first half. Some big plays.
Well, this is Alan Suber. Setting in the pot, looking, going deep. He's coming out there, and he connects with Charlie Parrish on a 52-yard strike. And Bethune-Cookman at that point had come back to have the lead. But then on the next drive, Florida A&M marches down the field, and O.J. Marchbanks marches into the end zone. But Florida A&M would miss the extra point. That seemed to ignite Bethune-Cookman as Eric Lash reverses, makes a brilliant catch, outruns Sam Copeland, outruns Troy Hart, takes it to the house, and Bethune-Cookman, on the strength of those two big plays and all the emotion, have the lead. They have to have confidence. But again, at the end of the first half last year, Alan Suber's bunch seem to be in the same position that they were in this year. They seem to have control, and that man Quinn Gray really picked up his play in the second half. I think Gray is doing a great job right now, but the Isaac Browns, DeMar Rose, Marco Juniuses, Charlie Allen, these guys got to step up and help him. He's made some beautiful passes. He's threaded some needles. Unfortunately, guys like Brown have let him down just a bit. They're going to make big plays in the passing game to get back to this one.
Michael Kidd's kickoff sails out of bounds. If you like what you just saw at the half, and who didn't?
Yes.
888 Mr. Video, beginning at $30, you can pick up Battle of the Bands, that halftime show. That was just tremendous. By the way,
it was 14 karat gold worth of tremendous.
Who won, in your
free
opinion?
Oh, man, I think it was excellent. You ain't going to open me in. No. Sometimes I think I'm the most wanted man in Tallahassee anyway, so I'm not going to go there.
Their diplomatic answer. Coach Alvin Wyatt's Bethune-Cookman Wildcats begin the second half, leading 14-9.
Well, the one interception did burn Quinn Gray, 50% passing, but again, he had, by my count, three or four drops, Dwayne, and guys got to hold on, make big plays, much like Jaquay Nunley did last year in the second half of the Florida Classic.
Well, first and 10 for Gray and his mates from the 36-yard line. They trail, time ran out on the play clock also.
Wow, he took too long chain at the line.
Now, you come out of halftime, you talk with your team. Your first play
by the offense,
scrimmage
occurs.
I think Quinn got to the line, saw something that he was unfamiliar with, tried to make a check, and I'm not quite sure everybody was on the same page of the book of the check or the adjustment in play. Basically, what he was doing at the time was changing the line of scrimmage, and he just couldn't get it off.
Loss of five on the penalty. Out of the shotgun, Gray with time to throw, has a receiver and a first down and more. He was down on the play. Marco Julius, Rasheen Mathis there to finally stop him.
Well, this is just a little quick in pattern. About 10 yards down and he squares, then turns it back to the outside and picks up big yardage. Again, Quinn Gray with a nice read, finding the receiver in the seam, letting him run after the catch. And that's where Florida A&M and this Gulf offense have been so effective ever since Billy Joe got here. Their ability with their receivers to take short pass plays and turn them into big, long gainers. And to this point, we have seen that. And that's Bubba Hubbard, the all-conference, all-world linebacker for Bethune-Cookman, who was down. And to say if they lose him for any extended period of time would be almost catastrophic.
He's their major presence in the middle. Anthony Bubba Hubbard from Sarasota came into this game with 55 and a half tackles, 39 solos.
And that's the engine that drives this defense. You know, it's kind of like a situation where they talk about offense selling tickets and defense winning championships. Well, the secondary garners all the attention. But guys like him, tremendous run stoppers, aggressive blitzers on defensive front, help make the lives easier for the likes of Terrell Robinson and the All-American Rasheen Mathis.
So it's first and 10 after the big play at the 37-yard line of Bethune-Cookman and their antsy feet along the interior line.
A little bit premature. Might have been Kevin Johnson.
False start on the offense, 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
And see, that's got to frustrate Billy Joe seated right there with his brain trust upstairs. And that's Coach Alvin Wyatt. But back to Billy Joe for a second. He's got to be frustrated that whenever his team starts moving, they seem to shoot themselves in the foot.
This is where Coach Joe watches every game, from the press box. He says it's the best view he has of the field. And Gray going up top, looking for DeMar Bowe, overthrows him. Coach Joe told us in a conversation that for him, he sees everything the best from up there. All he sees down on the ground are legs.
Right.
So for him, this is the way he views it.
And there you can see as we pull back, he has got a seat well above the playing surface in the rafters of this big historic building here in Orlando.
Who's going to argue with his record? So it must work for him. On the ground, his Rattlers keep it with O.J. Marchbanks getting near the 30-yard line.
Boy, they just flooded to the left side that time. Kind of coloring Larry Ram with a pull from Terry Logan. And that opened up a big hole and sizable yardage gain.
Pickup of 6, 3rd and 4. Gray elects to keep it, has room for the first down, slides near the 19-yard line.
First time that we've called the number of Mr. Gray on the quarterback draw. Half a step back, look at him. Follow big number 77, Kevin McCullough. And he picks up the first down. So just what the doctor ordered coming out of intermission for Quinn Gray and the Rattlers. A smooth-looking drive here to open the second half.
On 1st and 10, from the 23-yard line, Gray bearing down on him with a blitz was Jimmy Williams, and Gray gets up probably a little lighter.
Boy, I tell you, he's going to feel that one in the training room tomorrow. Off an outside blitz, Williams comes unblocked, and he forces Quinn Gray. Watch number 48. From the right-hand side of your screen, and Gray, pocket presence, he feels that blitz coming, so he releases it a half a count early, and the pass goes right. Big third down, second down situation for the Rattlers here.
2nd and 10, Florida A&M trails Bethune-Cookman 14-9 early in the third quarter, and Quinn Gray doesn't like what he sees across the field from him, so he takes time to talk about it.
Well, that's the disadvantage of the no huddle. Sometimes when you don't huddle, there's a little bit of confusion, and it's best for the senior to talk about it.
One-on-one. Bring it on.
Not getting enough basketball? Get in the game with all your favorite Florida teams at sunshinenetwork.com.
This month on Dish On Demand, pay-per-view.
You're saying that all the pretty girls I've met lately aren't really pretty.
Shallow Hal. Orange County.
Rollerball! We play to win.
Rollerball. Take a break from routine TV or a pay-per-view movie from Dish On Demand.
The Gravity Games, a gathering of the biggest stars in alternative sports, live and uncut, this August on pay-per-view. America's most watched sports and lifestyle festival. Athletes competing skateboarding, bike stunt, flexing in line and freestyle motocross, live for the first time and on pay-per-view. Contact your local cable operator partner now.
It's the Sunday night journey on Sunshine. Ease on in.
The Florida Citrus Bowl, home to the Florida Classic. 2nd and 10 for Florida A&M, which trails 14-9 against arch rival Bethune-Cookman. Kelsey Lordius is stopped by William Hudson and teammates in the backfield.
Well, I tell you, Steve Baggs that time from his defensive end position really stepped up to turn that play inside. And Quinn Gray, watch number 52, he's going to step outside, do a good job forcing that ball carrier, Lordius, right up into the inside. And Baggs is right there to get credit for the stop.
Once again, the Wildcat defensive unit responds. William Hudson.
And there on the other side is William Hudson. So on the previous play, the left end bags does the work. And here they switch sides, and coming off of just a straight bull rush from the outside was William Hudson. And he sacks Quinn Gray. And now it's fourth in a month of Sundays for the Rattler offense. I tell you, this Gulf Coast offense is so effective at racking up yards. They are firmly pushed to the test right here.
So it's fourth and 18 from the 31-yard line. And Gray's going for it. Hit the receiver. First down, Florida A&M, Isaac Brown, the senior. Beats Ed Goings on the play.
And this is just your basic post pattern, Dwayne. I mean, a little bit soft in the coverage. Watch him. He's going to break it right on the inside of Goings. And this is a strike by Gray. He splits the seam with Mathis a little bit late coming over to that zone. And they pick up a big first down. Wow.
Isaac Brown, 5'9", 170-pound senior from Baton Rouge. Leads the team in receptions and yards. Came into this one with two touchdowns, a 26-yard reception and run that set up a first down. On second and four. And a signal touchdown for O.J. Marchbanks.
That's a clutch drive right there, folks. That, my friends, is a championship-caliber drive. Understanding that you got to get some points coming out of the half. And look at the power of the line. Look right there. They get a little pull up into the middle right there. Great surge, and Marchbanks takes it to the house. Well, there was a wall up there. Kevin McCullough once again doing a great job along with help from Terry Logan. And now the Rattlers are looking to try to make it a three-point game by going to the two-point conversion.
Well, we remember earlier a missed extra point. Thus, this decision by Coach Joe. Gray to the air. There is a flag in the end zone. It was Rasheen Mathis defending against Marco Junius.
Boy, Paco and Rasheen Mathis talking a little trash. Mathis a little bit early getting there, according to the official. Let's check it out right here. They run a little crossing route.
On the defense.
And
to the goal line.
Boy, that's oh so close. And Coach Wyatt is in disbelief of that particular call right there as well.
Gazing at the clock, realizing that his team must once again answer. This time it's on the ground. Lordius is into the end zone. And it's a three-point lead for Florida A&M. More from the Florida Classic after these messages.
I've got to tell you, a few weeks ago, I saw the White's metal detector on TV. In no time at all, my local dealer had me out treasure hunting. I was finding the good stuff my first day. And the best part? You can see what's in the ground before you dig it up.
Your treasure hunting adventure can start right now. Call for your free catalog.
My wife said I needed a healthy hobby. She's proud of weight I've lost and really proud of this.
Call now.
Get into business with America's oldest and largest shutter manufacturer, All Florida Hurricane Shutters, featuring Magnum Force, the complete line of hurricane protection products. Your customers can receive insurance discounts, comply with building codes, and find real peace of mind. All Florida Hurricane Shutters and the Magnum Force line of hurricane protection products, serving the state of Florida and the Southeast United States since 1954. Call 1-800-HURRICANE or visit our website.
If you love pro basketball, your season never ends. The Miracle hosts the Portland Fire Sunday night at 7:30 as we celebrate National Kids Day. Lower bowl tickets start at $8. Call 877-WNBA-TICKS.
Order a milkshake as a token of your own appreciation.
Well, you've completed your grill training, so I'm proud to make you one of us.
Then I'm ready to make hamburgers.
Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
Bean Crock.
In 1977, Shakespeare introduced the ugly stick, a rod so strong, so durable, and yet so sensitive. It became the number one selling rod in America. You'd think by now the competition would have done it. Guess not. Ugly Stick by Shakespeare. Still America's strongest, most sensitive rod.
Florida A&M now leads Bethune-Cookman 17-14 in the Florida Classic early in the third quarter. Other games in the Eastern Athletic Conference, South Carolina State on a late season roll as Will Jeffries ends his great career, upsetting North Carolina A&T in Greensboro 15-14.
Actually, that game was in Orangeburg, and of course the Hampton Pirates, big win over Morgan, 35-20. And what that means is that this game right here, these last, 25 minutes or so of all the marbles in the conference.
The winner of this game moves on, wins the conference, and earns a berth in the NCAA Division I AA playoffs.
And as you can see, Florida A&M on the top spot with a 6-1 mark in the conference. Should they fall, they would be tied with Bethune-Cookman 6-2, and the head-to-head tiebreaker would swing the championship in the direction of the Mighty Wildcats. Of course, Florida A&M looking to win the championship again by virtue of a stellar second half against Alan Suber and the Wildcats.
Suber and the Wildcats now must try to answer as they trailed 17-14. Suber doing damage to the Florida A&M defensive unit on the ground. First down for the Wildcats.
Well, this is one of the few times you'll see anybody in America able to turn the corner against the quickness of the Florida A&M defensive pursuit. The linebackers are so fast. Suber gets down outside. He's able to get outside containment that right now. He got past Chris Sessions, and once he turned that corner, the lane, the area was open for him to pick up the first down.
Ball out to the 38-yard line for the Wildcats. And this time, Sean Dixon, a number of other players are there to greet Marcus Goggins.
Boy, I tell you, that Rattler defense is making it real tough up the middle. And remember, Alex Fortson is not in the middle of that Rattler defense right now. So they've had to change a few things. I believe that's Carl Shazor that's in there right now, kind of clogging up that middle. We haven't got a report on Fortson's injury, but he has been a vital cog in that Rattler D this season. He's no longer in there.
Second down, Suber, who already has 14 yards rushing, is escorted out of bounds by Akia Bynum.
Yeah, but that's because number 98 Brown right there tapped Bynum on the head. Does a good job stepping up from the end position. He's going to string that play outside. See? He wanted to turn it back up in there, but number 98 was right there to take away his hole, so he just had to eat it. That's a good job of Florida A&M staying at home. The end gets outside to force a later pitch. The linebacker rotates outside, strings the play out, so Suber loses yardage and brings up a big, long third down situation.
So Brown, 6'2", 285-pound junior from nearby Sanford, Florida. Third 14. Bethune-Cookman now trails. Game seesawing back and forth. Suber, the pocket breaks down. He elects to throw and has a receiver. Eric Reed on the reception. Levy Brown there defensively. But not before Reed had enough for the first down.
Well, he's a master at improvisation is Alan Suber. Great protection up front. Even better coverage downfield. He steps up, shows run, lost a strike out there to Reed. It's hauled in and a big third down conversion.
That really is improvisation because you think he's going to run.
And you have to respect that because the kid has 4-4 speed. But he draws the defense to him, allows the receiver to get behind him, and he completes the big pass.
So the 15-yard pickup gives the Wildcats ball at midfield, and Marcus Goggins gets into the secondary, where Shedrick Copeland stops him.
Yeah, but he got a good trap block from Darren Herndon, who blocked down, and Napoleon Joseph came right across from him. And that opened the hole in that gap for Goggins to shoot through there. And Goggins has been somewhat contained this afternoon. And it's shocking that Bethune-Cookman within three when Marcus Goggins hasn't been all that effective today.
Well, that 10-yard run sets up the first down at the 40-yard line of Florida A&M. So the Wildcats now mounting an impressive drive to answer Florida A&M's. It's Taji Parrish taking the pitch, ending up out of bounds. Levy Brown was right with him.
The ubiquitous Levy Brown all over the field, but Alan Zuber laboring just a little bit. He took a lick. Alan Zuber took a shot after he delivered that pitch, and he's going to have to collect himself just a little something. Now, when you're quarterback in the wishbone, or in this variation of the wishbone known as the Y-bone, you got to be a physical warrior.
Pick up a 5 on the play.
It's reminiscent kind of like when Joe Hamilton was quarterback at Georgia Tech. Ralph Friedgen was got it off, and he expected him to do a lot. Question is, will he route in the second half, in the fourth quarter?
On 2nd and 5, Wildcats keep it on the ground. Goggins with a couple. You know, we call Levy Brown's name a lot tonight, number 11 for Florida A&M. He leads them in tackles from the secondary position, but it's by design.
That's right, because they use their defensive front to clog the line at the point of attack. You have the quickness of the linebackers that normally string plays out, and he from the free safety is able to roam and get to the area and just basically follow the ball. It's like having a spy in there at all times.
Came into the game with 84 tackles. On 3rd down, the Rattlers respond. Chris Sessions.
Well, Alan Zuber is having a conversation, a passionate conversation with the coach. Now, I guess that time there was a breakdown in communication where I think they thought he was supposed to fake that dive and pitch to Taji Parrish. Florida A&M steps up and recognizes that Copeland in there right with some help from Sessions. And here we go. Florida A&M roll the dice on their first drive coming out after the intermission. And they got a big 1st down on 4th down. Here, Bethune-Cookman does the same.
4th and 2. Bethune-Cookman trailing 17-14. Ball at the 38-yard line. And Alan Zuber is gang tackled.
Well, if he got that 1st down, he got that 1st down on nothing but his unadulterated strength at 5'10", 170 pounds. Oh, and we just had some fisticuffs. Look at this strength. He's almost spun out of the tackle. And look at, fake the dive.
He drugged Carlos Moore with him.
Look at this, is just, look at the strength of Zuber there.
Well, there are markers down on the field as tempers begin to flare.
Well, there was a late flag in there after the play had been blown dead. Ben Coleman might have been one of the culprits for Florida A&M. And Florida A&M having apparently stopped Bethune-Cookman will be assessed with a personal foul penalty. And again, they shoot themselves in the foot. Uncharacteristic of Billy Joe's team, a mental mistake like that.
So much on the line in this game. The winner gets it in NCAA 1AA. I'll get it out.
Well, let's see.
This 1AA playoff berth.
Apparently, Florida A&M's going to retain possession.
Levin Wyatt wants an explanation. Jerome Boger, our referee, is holding him and explaining it to his quarterback. Matter of protocol.
Well, you feel real confident when you got Mr. Boger running things.
After play was over, White gets the ball 1st and 10. But after the play was over, we have an unsportsmanlike penalty against Florida A&M. They will be penalized 15 yards and give the ball 1st and 10. Bethune was out short on the 4th down.
So the defense is rewarded for making the play, but this conduct cost them yardage.
Well, watch, a little smack talk, and I think one of the big nasties up front, maybe that was I couldn't see that. Somebody
Ben,
got a hand
Ben
in there.
Coleman being pushed away.
Yeah. And maybe that was Coleman being thrown out of the game and it being thrown out by the umpire, Dwight Pettiford. Pettiford umpiring and officiating his final Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference game this season after 25 years as an official. And, you know him from up your way, just a stellar individual. And, you know, the officiating corps, as talented as it is in the MEAC, is certainly going to long for someone with his experience.
Mr. Pettiford.
The defensive player has been disqualified.
Dwight Pettiford is also one of Raleigh, North Carolina's finest in his other job. So out of one uniform and into the other, and you see Ben Coleman has been ejected from the game.
Speaking of out of one uniform, Ben Coleman with an early shower. And just got to keep your head in the game, young fella.
So Coleman, a 6'5", 290-pound senior from St. Paul, Minnesota, has been ejected right in for Florida A&M. 7:29 to go in the third quarter, and he and his Rattler mates lead 17-14. First and 10, Quinn Gray runs right into Wildcats.
Looked like there might have been a problem with the exchange from center that time between Gray and Kent Jones. But Florida A&M with the no huddle, keeping the pace quick. Bethune-Cookman having trouble making defensive adjustments.
No pickup on the play. Out of the shotgun from his 10-yard line. Gray going quickly to the air. Has a receiver and a first down, or close to it. Well, Marco Junius with Jimmy Williams defending.
The man they call Paco. Nothing fancy, little fake of the play action, and he hits him with a slant route. That's a play that Jerry Rice has turned into perfection during his Hall of Fame career with the 49ers and now the Raiders. Pitch and catch, and a FAMU first down.
At the 30-yard line. Lordius, who started off so impressively in the first quarter and has been pretty steady tonight, brought down by Steve Bangs.
Well, you look at the big guys up front. They get a little trapped there, and he shows some patience waiting for the hole to open, does Lordius. But up front, the big nasties of FAMU doing a good job, seemingly beginning to wear down the interior of the Wildcat defensive front.
Lordius, 68 yards on 13 carries. They're going to the air. Isaac Brown has it. First down, Micah Simmons defensively, but not in time to prevent the chains from moving another 10-plus yards.
Well, this pass right here, this harkens me back to that Hampton game we did a few weeks ago where Joe Taylor told us he thought Bethune-Cookman had difficulty playing in space. These are quick routes underneath the Wildcat D, and when they're spread out, they're having difficulty keeping up with the quick Rattler skill players in open areas. And I think we'll have a timeout here. It goes to Bethune-Cookman.
Timeout, Bethune. This is their first charge timeout.
Brown, the senior, 4 receptions, 61 yards. Can the Wyatt offense, defense, stop the Florida A&M offense?
Not getting enough basketball? Get in the game with all your favorite Florida teams at sunshinenetwork.com.
If you're hounded by a disobedient dog, now you can control your pet with Pet Trainer, the electronic pet training tool that works like magic. Just give the desired command and press the button. Pet Trainer emits an ultrasonic sound that you can't hear, but commands your dog's attention. Harmless but effective, your dog will snap to attention and listen to your command the very first time you use it. Pet Trainer works great for cats, too. Don't let a nightmare like this happen. Pet Trainer trains pets for their own safety. And use Pet Trainer for your own safety as well.
The use of ultrasonic sound is humane and extremely effective.
Imagine a playful pet you can be proud of. Order Pet Trainer, the safe, effective way to train your pet. Only $19.95.
Credit card users call toll-free 1-800-495-9900. That's 1-800-495-9900. Or send check or money order to the address on your screen. For quickest delivery, use your credit card and call now. 1-800-495-9900.
Now, your one and only regional sports newscast, The Inside Angle.
Who is a Grammatica brother most likely to pick up a hitchhiker?
Next to Florida Sports News, weeknights at 10 on Sunshine Network.
Florida A&M head coach Billy Joe watching from his usual perch in the press box. His Rattlers lead 17-14. He's in his eighth season, 6-9, 26-0, and he has quite the mind. Undergraduate degrees in economics and history, a master's in secondary education. At one point, he was a stockbroker, but said that he just been coaching too much. The Rattlers with the ball on the ground, and it's Kelsey Lourdes with a pickup of six before Steve Bagg stopped him.
Well, that was a tough run that time. As you can look at the attendance, 70,112, the third largest in Florida Classic history, the ninth largest in the illustrious history, Dwayne, of the Florida Citrus Bowl, which was where I guess I witnessed Georgia Tech win the national championship in 1991.
Lourdes on second down, up the sideline, goes down hard, will not get in before Willie Dobie takes him out of bounds.
Well, they've been pounding up the middle. So you fake and you pull everybody with the sweep. You get good offensive line play as they seal the line to the inside. The wall is created, and he tiptoes down the sidelines for another Rattler first down. And this Gulf Coast offense, it's cranking up, DB.
The ball now at the 25-yard line. Steve Baggs there defensively.
And, you know, these big guys up front for Florida A&M, I mean, they've got some significant girth and mass up there. He goes 275, 320. 280, 330, and 290, and you're going up against guys who are about 215 to 240 on the interior of Bethune-Cookman. They start wearing down, and you can see Florida A&M begin to seize command at the point of attack.
Second and 10 from the 25. Gray in trouble, gets out of it amazingly, but eventually goes down. Bubba Hubbard.
Boy, that was the most exciting no-yard gain you'll ever see. I'm telling you, Quinn Gray with a heads-up job there of avoiding the sack. You know, at 6'4", 230, it takes a big-time shot to get him down. He breaks three tackles there before struggling back to the line of scrimmage, but I'm struck by Lombardi's remark. Fatigue makes cowards of us all. A lot of missed tackles by big guys up front. Guys beginning to look a little tired there, wearing maroon and gold.
Very impressive, Coach Gray.
Great coaches all quote each other.
Third and 10 from the 25. Gray going through the air and has DeMar Bowe on the far sideline, close to another first down, but Quinn Gray is down.
And I think there's going to be a roughing the passer call on Steve Baggs. I think Baggs got there a little bit late, and Gray looked like he took a shot. Man, he might have, oh my goodness, he may have gotten his bell rung. Here it comes from behind. That's Baggs. He looked like he got about three steps. Good job of Gray on the hot read, picking out DeMar Bowe.
On the defense, half the distance goal line, automatic first down.
And that'll bring on the second string quarterback is Lemuel Adams, a transfer from Washington State, who has a world talent, hasn't seen a significant amount of playing time, but Bags that time looked like he got there about a second and a half late, and Quinn Gray paid for it.
If it is Adams, he's 6 of 12 in passing this season for 78 yards, a 200-pound senior from Sacramento. There also is in reserve number 18, Reggie Hayes, 6'4", 195-pound junior from Miami, who has thrown 15 passes, completing 6 for 90 yards. So not a wealth of experience. Look at Lemuel Adams, number 7. Mark just spoke to him. He appears to be the one that would come in first. Not a lot of experience, though, Mark, when it comes to the passing game. Quinn Gray is down. We'll see if he can continue to go. More from the Florida Cat after this.
The Bow.
Resistance becomes strength, becomes power. The power to change and reshape your entire body. This is Bowflex, an entire gym in one easy-to-use machine. So powerful, it delivers over 60 health club quality exercises with up to 410 pounds of resistance in any room in your home. Strength training with Bowflex is so effective that we guarantee you'll get the results you want in 6 weeks or less. One simple workout. 20 minutes a day, 3 days a week. Bowflex is real. The results are real. You can own one with no money down and payments as low as $33 per month. Call right now for a free video brochure. Bowflex, the power is yours.
If you love pro basketball, your season never ends. The Miracle hosts the Portland Fire Sunday night at 7:30 as we celebrate National Kids Day. Lower bowl tickets start at $8. Call 877-WNBA-6.
We've always gone our own way in the South. How we drive, where we drive, what we drive. The kind of cars, the kind of trucks. Like this Dodge Ram Quad Cab. The only full-size pickup with four-wheel doors and a full-size bed. Plus the biggest brakes wheels in its class. You'll find down the road a piece at Truckville. Known in these parts as your new South Dodge dealer.
Mickey Mouse and Walt Disney World, title sponsors for the Florida Classic here in Orlando, Florida. Mickey, didn't know you played football. Florida A&M leads 17-14.
Wiki, and there's Quinn Gregg clearly looking like he has his bell rung. We saw him earlier in the season against North Carolina A&T at the end of the first half. Leave the field under similar circumstances, but at that point he had an entire halftime, that is, to collect himself. Doesn't have that long right now. We've seen Lemuel Adams with one of the more unbelievable long pass completions you'll ever see. He's mobile, he's agile, he's hostile, and he get it done.
And he's on the field, first and goal from the 8-yard line. He's out of the shotgun. He elects to run. And closing quickly is Toro Robinson.
Well, what better way to get your feet wet than a quarterback draw and allow your athletic quarterback to take a shot? He has the quicks to get up inside, and Toro Robinson wants to deliver a shot, pardon me, so that he thinks about it the next time.
Second and goal from the 6. 3:35 to go in the third quarter of the Florida Classic. Rattlers looking for more and get it!
Well, Kelsey Lordy is right up the gut, DB. Kenneth Jones, Kevin McCullough once again. They're just doing a great job up the gut. 74 and 77, and he just once again, with some more help from Terry Logan, 51. They open up a big hole, and Florida A&M has gone to ground to seize command of this game. Kelsey Lordy is with his 8th TD of the season, and Florida A&M looked like they were in a little bit of trouble at the end of the first half. Just about on cruise control right now.
Lordy. And the extra point to give the Rattlers more of a cushion. Number 6. Goes over the 100-yard mark and gives the Rattlers a larger lead.
Now is Florida's one and only regional sports newscast, and it's come at you exclusively on Sunshine Network. The Inside Angle.
Magic Man Grant Hill paid a visit.
3 surgeries, 2 seasons. I just rushed it back. You don't judge the painting until it's done. Time to get the rust off.
Covering every team across the state. Still, Florida Sports News. Weeknights at 10, only on Sunshine Network.
Well, look at the offensive line play up front of the FAMU Rattlers, DB. You're going to see Terry Logan, 51, Kenneth Jones, 74, and Kevin McCullough. Look at 51 right there. Big Terry Logan open up that hole. He's converted from center to guard, and you can see Now, Kelsey Lourdes knows where to find the hole, and he's up over the 100-yard mark, and we thought that the Rattlers were going to have to run the football. He's getting it done today.
Rattlers closing on the kickoff. So now Bethune-Cookman finds itself in a little deeper hole, trailing by 10.
Well, I think it's time for them to take a page out of FAMU's book, spread the Rattler defense out, try to work with their skilled players underneath, and then set something up to go deep. Suber, a great pass. They focused a great deal on trying to run the option. I think that the focus from here on out may be the short passing game to open up the inside.
Ball at the 21. Suber keeps it himself. Has a first down with a nifty run.
Boy, that is. The footwork, the field generalship. I mean, he was able to turn a busted play into nothing. I mean, we talked about Suber's improvisational skills. Fake the dive. Good job of jumping it, jumping the defense that time. Was the linebacker stepping up to force him back to the inside. That was John Edwards who forced him to the inside. But Suber just made a play. Now, you're talking about a kid when he came out of high school, Alan Suber, the second-rated quarterback in the state. If he's 3 inches taller and about 30 pounds heavier, he's probably playing in Gainesville this evening.
Pickup of 10, set up another first down.
That's Henry. Javon Henry, I believe. A little trap action right here. Gets the block down. Well, those guys, Robbie Reese, Darren Herndon, get off the block real well. Seal FAMU to the inside and allow Logan to pick up the first down. Check that, Henry.
So the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats continue to move the markers. They trail by 10, 2:30 to go in the Florida Classic. Ball at the 48-yard line. Alan Suber at quarterback. The pitch to Taji Parrish. Check that, it's Eric Lash. Levy Brown on the tackle.
Well, FAMU that time tries to come up the middle with a blitz, and Suber is able to escape it. See, to come up the middle, Suber escapes it, gets the pitch out to Lash, and look at that area. FAMU getting caught being a little nosy. You know, you got to stay at home against the option. You got to stay in your lanes. FAMU was aggressive up the middle. And I believe that Sanders, Joe Sanders, who's down right now.
And remember, Sanders came in for Alex Sportson, who was hurt earlier.
So watch Sanders. He's going to play off the block and get just a little nosy. And ooh, my goodness, there's the chop block. Oh, man. Wow. Bethune-Cookman tried to block down. They blocked down on Sanders below the belt. And he may not get up for a minute.
Sanders, 6 feet, 245-pound junior from Rockledge, Florida. Just mentioned he came in for Alex Fortson, who was injured earlier.
That's huge. Now Clifton Moore, the defensive coordinator, going to have to really get creative with his substitutions. You know, and that really is going to magnify the significance of Levy Brown. I mean, Levy Brown now from the free safety position is going to have to come up and be, you know, that much more effective in the center of the field in terms of run support without Sanders and without Fortson right there. And those are two vital cogs. Your FAMU struggle some up the middle. But watch number 11. He's the guy you're going to have to watch him in run support. And if you have to come up in run support, receivers may find it easier to get behind him as they did in the first half.
Another first down for Bethune-Cookman into Florida A&M territory. There are whistles and flags on the field. You're just joining us. Welcome into the Florida Classic from Orlando, Florida, the Florida Citrus Bowl. It's Florida A&M and Bethune-Cookman.
After the snap, false start on the offense. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
70,000 plus on hand this evening. Mark Gray and Dwayne Allen very happy. to call it for you. It's been an exciting game, back and forth. The winner of this one goes on to win the Mideastern Athletic Conference Championship and earn a berth in the playoffs.
And the loser goes home and has to deal with more bragging rights from the opposition for another 12 months.
It's first and 15 for Bethune-Cookman. Allen, so their electric quarterback, turns another big run on field, and it's very close to negating that last penalty with a first down.
Well, I've seen the kid Biden from the backside, number 52, out too many times this season, but that's in the background, trying to catch up with Zuber. He hit a second gear, and then a third gear, and almost spun out of a tackle. The reverse pivot, coming out to the end of the line, 52 having a beat on him, and just losing him. Kind of reminiscent of a play that Donovan McNabb made last year, escaping Bruce Smith. That's coming back home, kicking the Gatorade on the Washington Redskins sideline. That's great stuff by Subaru.
That 14-yard pickup sets up second and one. And it's no go. Carlos Moore coming in from his position as a safety.
Boy, I think he saw the hole. He shot the gap. And he got the back. Look at him. Backside. Somebody missed the block. I think that was... I couldn't see if that was Napoleon Joseph or Julius Franklin who was supposed to get to him. See, somebody goes inside, and Moore goes to the outside, and he runs right into the ball cap. Check that out. Carl Sapp, the redshirt sophomore from here, Orlando, who went inside, missed the assignment, or Moore to the outside, and he stops him. It's going to be a third and three. And as we, Florida A&M's defense, Dwayne, it's been a long time on the sideline. They should be rested and rest. But Bethune-Cookman's offensive front right now, really getting after him. At this time, Troy Hart picks himself up off the track. It's getting physical. It's safe from the faint of heart right now. You better tighten up that chin strap. Make sure you got enough eye block going to get through the fourth quarter. Because this ain't for the faint of heart right here. It's a man's world on the field in the Citrus Bowl right now.
With all due respect to Jamon. Third and three, 53 seconds to go in the third quarter. Bethune-Cookman looking for first down. And quarterback gets it into the end zone.
Allen Suber taking advantage of the physical play. Big nasty in the front. And he takes it to house. Allen Suber, it's a great play. Look at the discipline. Make the dive. Come down. I'ma keep it. Great cheeky move to the inside right there. And then look at him. From 0 to 50 in a millisecond. Allen Suber scoots 32 yards. Takes it to the house. Bethune-Cookman within four. Oh, that's why that young fella's so fun to watch. Mom April, Tampa, Grandma Pat Moore. You gotta love what little Allen is doing right here. Fake the dive, get to the outside, gonna say, no, I'm gonna keep it, turn it up inside. And once he gets into secondary, that's 4-4 speed, sprinter speed, receiver speed. He outruns everybody, and the Wildcats have their swagger back. I think, young fella, you might have found yourself a career.
Alvin Wyatt may not realize his team just scored.
Looks like Steve Harvey standing in front of the collector, doesn't he? With that tie on.
Allen Suber.
So you're right.
And the extra point makes it a three-point game. Bethune-Cookman now to Florida A&M, 24-21. And it's been punch and counterpunch.
It certainly has.
This game tonight.
You hit the nail on the head. This is just a knockdown, drag-out, heavyweight fight. We're just when you figure one opponent is ready to deliver the haymaker. The other guy gets up off the deck and comes back with a shot of his own. And as you can see, the Wildcat faithful feeling pretty good right now. But the burden of proof now comes up on the eighth-ranked defense in America right now to clamp down on Florida A&M. And I'm interested to see if Quinn Gray is going to be able to clear the cobwebs and lead the FAMU offense.
Isaac Brown allows the kickoff to sail into the end zone for a touchback. And the conference's number one ranked offense will take the field again against the number one ranked defense.
Irresistible force, immovable object. Was that your line earlier?
That was it. And Mr. Gray is back out on the field.
And you folks in Tallahassee who question the heart and the toughness of Quinn Gray, well, he just answered. So shut up.
Kelsey Lordius, who's already over 100 yards rushing on the ground for the game. Close to another first down.
Boy, that Lamar Demps and Kenneth Jones getting after it right now. I mean, they're just blasting Bethune-Cookman right up the gut. You know, Logan has moved over back to his Armiak center position, and he and McCullough and Lamar Demps are having their way with the interior of the Bethune-Cookman defensive front.
Whistles on the field. Florida A&M with that 9-yard pickup now has second and one.
Illegal substitution on the defense. 12 men on the field. 5-yard penalty. First down.
That is the third time that infraction has been assessed this game.
That's just amazing. That's just confusion on the sidelines. And if you look in the foreground of Coach Wyatt, we pull that next shot out, it'll be a look at his brother C.A. Wyatt.
On first down, it's never say die, Kelsey Lourdes, who is really hard to bring down.
Well, this is where you find out just how bad people want it. When you're a senior playing in your final classic, there are big plays like Alan Souter.
Florida A&M has the lead, 24-21.
I am Ruth Riley. My life revolves around sports. I love to watch sports and play sports. My favorite movie is Hoosiers. It's not a tough choice. The best we ever made. My mom means everything to me, and my family has been so supportive of me along the way. I do try to answer all my family. If people take the time to write to me, that's the least I can do is take the time to write them back.
For Miami Soul, to call 786-777-4SOL or log on to miamisoul.com.
Well, that's cute. Oh, it's just an N in the logo.
Cute? You don't know about the N?
What?
You seriously don't know, do you?
Tell me. Come on, tell me.
Rarely seen, many people don't believe these exist.
But they do. Our place.
Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
Will somebody just tell me about the N?
Fishing then, fishing now. As the needs of the avid angler have changed, so has Fluger, the legendary tackle manufacturer. Fluger is setting a new standard in quality and performance with Tryon series, Tryon spinning reels, Tryon bait casting reels, and Tryon graphite rods. Fishing has changed, but you can still rely on Fluger, a fishing tradition for over 120 years. Isn't it time you experience the legendary feel of a Fluger?
The Sunday Journey on Sunshine. Ease on in. Monday at 7 on Sunshine.
Back at the Florida Citrus Bowl in Orlando, Florida, the Florida Classic. It is down to one quarter and the season for Florida A&M and Bethune-Cookman. The Rattlers lead 24-21. The winner goes on to the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference crown and a postseason berth.
And Florida A&M, known through the Billy Joe era for their terrific wide-open air attack, has gone to the ground and had big success. And it looks like they're beginning to wear down the interior of Bethune-Cookman's defensive front.
Rattlers have it second and one at their 48. Quinn Gray, the record setter at quarterback, And this man has just had a tremendous game so far. Kelsey Lee is churning out Moore, finally running over Kenny Heatley and going down.
Well, they faked the dive up the middle, and that brought enough of the pursuit to the inside, which allows Lordius to get to the outside. Good blocks down there. If Isaac Brown, number two, is able to hold his block a little bit longer on Kenny Heatley, Lordius is probably still running. But again, this Rattler offense getting it done on the ground.
And now they're into Bethune-Cookman territory. A double reverse. Flea flicker back to Quinn Gray. Has a man open downfield. But the defensive secondary closes for Bethune-Cookman. Rasheen Mathis, the All-America.
Well, that's a good job of Bethune-Cookman that time, staying at home. Most coaches think you can take advantage of their aggressiveness because they pursue so well. This time they stay at home on the flea flicker. Great protection for Gray. He had an opportunity to get that ball to Charlie Allen. He let it go just a little bit too late, got too much air under it, and he threw right into the teeth of the double coverage with Torrell Robinson back there getting a little help. And the pass, and I think he had some help from Alex Goings as well.
So now it's second and 10 at the 44-yard line of Bethune-Cookman. There is a flag down on the play. So this may all be brought back.
They had that little slot screen set up. Little pitch and catch action. Let the lineman pull. It was set up well. But I'm wondering, did the Rattlers set up?
Apparently they did not. Numbers through three quarters of play here.
And it's the story. Well, both teams doing admirable jobs running the football. Bethune able to claw to within 5 yards. FAMU and Quinn Gray finding the range in the passing game in the third quarter. Still only one turnover to this point. But you look at that time of possession, it only looks like it's about a minute and a half or 2 minutes. But with their 23 minutes and 35 seconds, FAMU's offensive front has pounded on Bethune-Cookman's undersized defensive front. And I think that's the difference right now. Can the Wildcats' defensive front suck it up to stop the Rattler O?
Second and 15. Florida A&M at the 48-yard line. Gray, under pressure, releases to someone out of the backfield. But boy, does Bethune-Cookman's defensive unit respond on O.J. Marchbanks and Steve Baggs.
Boy, Baggs gets credit for the stop that time. But you got to give even greater props. Aaron Shepard in there that time with the pressure. Boy, he read that play. And Billy Joe goes back to the drawing board. It's a third and long situation, but he's had the modest touch in terms of play calling here in these situations since the intermission.
Billy Joe, one of three active Division I AA coaches with 200-plus career victories, 219. His team on third and 20. Great, plenty of time to throw. And there must have been a mix-up on coverage because it was nowhere near a receiver, unless you want to suggest Dennis Bonga was there.
Well, you know, when we were talking earlier about the hot receivers, well, Quinn Gray ran a hot receiver that he thought was going to run an in. So, I checked that. He thought he was going to run an out. And he threw that pass to the outside. I think it was in the general direction of Dennis Bonga. But that ball was well outside. And Bethune-Cookman's defense has given the offense an opportunity to grab old man Moe.
And defending on the play was Taji Parrish, Mr. Versatility for Bethune-Cookman. T.J. Smith barely gets it off. Mathis fields it at the 15-yard line and goes down quickly.
Boy, that Carlos Moore having a big-time game in all aspects of it. Number 24 just all over it. Look at just how close Smith is to having this block. Boy, I tell you, a whisker just by the hair of the chinny chin chin. Do they get that punt off? But here's Alan Suber now directing a confident offense. They've got to feel good about themselves, and they've got to be a little bit of doubt in Florida A&M's mind right now.
First and 10 from the 14. Wildcats trail by three. And it's Suber, stopped by Sean Kelly.
There's a freshman inserted to the lineup, boy. And I'm telling you, this kid, Sean Kelly, has a future as bright as it was earlier this afternoon here in Orlando, Dwayne. I mean, he's aggressive and tenacious in terms of getting to the quarterback. He has the quickness to play the run. He's going to get bigger and more physical after those training tables and some time in the weight room. I think a star is born at the defensive end position to rank with the likes of Jerron Daley and the person of Sean Kelly.
On second and five, Suber out of the shotgun. Cannot get it to his receiver.
And he was trying to go to Taji Parrish, and once again, Mr. Moore in there on the coverage.
So now Suber begins to think and look at the clock a little.
Well, look, Kelly with the pressure from the outside, and Suber just didn't step up in the pocket and deliver that pass with any, you know, confidence to it. It was like he touched that pass and kind of hoped it would find the receiver's hands.
Alan Suber and the Bethune-Cookman Wildcats trail by three in the fourth quarter of the Florida Classic, third and five at their 14-yard line. Out of the shotgun is Suber. And he has the first down, or is very close.
Copeland, outstanding job that time by Jesse Copeland. Sticking with Alan Suber, he kind of ran it, forced him to the sideline, used the sideline as a fringe. They may have shoved him out before he picked up the first down. But he did not. So Suber once again making a play. And I'm wondering about him physically right now, not in terms of, you know, his health, but his energy level. I mean, he expends a lot of energy. This is a high-risk offense that puts a greater burden on the quarterback to play a full 60 minutes.
Well, he has it at the 28-yard line. And it's Javon Henry barreling his way downfield before running head-on into Levy Brown.
Boy, Levy Brown saves the touchdown. Boy, great off-tackle trap action right here. Cecil Chapman and LaShawn Dixon open the hole, and Henry is into the secondary. And give props to Levy Brown coming up to knock a running back that outweighs him by about 40 pounds. Henry at 238 pounds. Levy Brown at 175, and the 175-pounder won it.
Another first down for the Wildcats. Nakia Bynum snuffs this one out.
Boy, he jumped over a block to get into the Wildcat backfield to make that play.
So far, Suber 6 of 10, 160 yards passing.
And he's taking some shots, too, in the running game. But you know,
boy, he's made some electric plays. We said these two would be principal, and they have not disappointed
us. They certainly haven't. Alan Suber, number one in total offense in the conference this season, 160 yards passing, 84 yards rushing. Quinn Gray getting it done basically in the air.
On second down, the Florida A&M defense with Carlos Moore leading the way closes in on Taji Parrish and drops him for a loss.
Well, that's the option play, where you've got a trap to the near side and a pull back to the far side. Taji Parrish tried to take the pitch up into the inside and go back out, and Moore stayed at home and was not going to be fooled. That misdirection is designed to create confusion. Florida A&M was not confused.
You notice those uniforms the Wildcats are wearing. They were designed by their head coach, Alvin Wyatt. They were debuted at homecoming earlier this season. Wyatt, as his quarterback Suber calls timeout to talk about things, enjoys designing. And obviously a sartorial man.
Sartorially splendid, no less.
And he designed these new uniforms. But his Wildcats need to design some points. They trail 24-21.
I am Ruth Riley. My life revolves around sports. I love to watch sports, to play sports. My favorite movie is Hoosiers. It's not a tough choice. The best movie ever made. My mom means everything to me, and my family's been so supportive of me along the way. I do try to answer all my family. If people take the time to write to me, that's the least I can do is take the time to write them back.
For Miami Soul tickets, call 786-777-4SOL or log on to MiamiSoul.com.
Oh, yeah, I got that,
thank
honey.
You.
Do you like when Daddy help me?
Well, that sucks.
Yeah, I really liked her.
Yeah, she seemed like a lovely girl. Looks like you could use a refreshing Mike's Hard Lemonade.
You're on.
A hard day calls for a hard lemonade. Make it Mike's.
Why do we call this a freeze? Because it's cold.
Then why do we call this chili?
We don't need to bribe kids to eat here.
Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
The new Synergy Steel Reel. Stainless steel housing, lightweight graphite frame, oversized button for easy casting, double padded handle adjustable for left or right hand use, dual pickup pins for dependable retrieve.
Dad, you accidentally picked up my reel again?
Sorry, I must have got it mixed up.
Synergy Steel from Shakespeare.
Are they biting?
Putting a new spin on spin casting.
Don't let those lost weekend blues get you down when your weekend is all said and done. What you really need is a little Sunday night journey. We'll lure you into a solid block of outdoor programming with tips from some of the best experts on hunting and fishing. So kick back, get comfortable, and ease on in for a Sunday night journey on Sunshine.
Sunshine Network offers fans an up-close look at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers Monday night at 9 o'clock during Bucs Diaries. Host Paul Kennedy provides behind-the-scenes access to players and coaches through exclusive interviews and innovative features. Bucs Diaries, Monday night at 9 p.m. only on Sunshine Network. Here on the network at the moment, the Florida Classic. It's Florida A&M leading Bethune-Cookman 24-21 at the Citrus Bowl. And Alan Suber going down, gets it away, and very nearly has a touchdown to Tarion Hubbard.
Boy, that's just a great play all the way around by Suber against an all-out blitz. He steps up in the pocket after showing that he was going to take this ball off, and Saquon Dow is in coverage. But watch this. This is a terrific adjustment by Hubbard, who couldn't quite turn his body all the way around to haul that in. If that pass is over the opposite shoulder, it's 6 points. But the Dow was definitely up on that particular instance.
And there is another player down on the field wearing green, white, and orange. We have seen this a number of times. This has been a very exacting game for Billy Joe.
Yeah, it's been pretty physical too. Taking a toll on the Florida A&M interior players and linebackers. Ow!
Florida A&M, there's Billy Joe now standing up. Very concerned about this because if the score does hold, then he has to prepare for a postseason game that is not going to be easy.
But unlike last year, my friend, where after a physical, tough Florida Classic, there was but a week to prepare, Florida A&M, because of the unfortunate events of September 11th, will get another bye week. Each of these teams is off next week, so they would have an opportunity to collect themselves and at least prepare for a tough 1AA championship opponent.
Florida A&M defense, as has the Bethune-Cookman defense, has bent but not broken today. 70,000 plus at the Citrus Bowl. Fifth consecutive year this event has been held here. Walt Disney World Resort's a title sponsor. It seems to get bigger and bigger every year. Even the Gray family may make it down.
No, I get the feeling the Quinn Grace family is probably already here. And it's great to be here in Orlando once again.
Well, so far, Mark, what do you think? We cannot get a sense of rhythm in this game because, as we said, there's been an answer, another answer. No one's dominated.
Well, I think it really is going to come down basically to a team with the ball inside the last 3 minutes with a chance to win the contest. I just got the feeling at this point, Dwayne, that Alan Suber is now the focal point of Bethune-Cookman's offense. They just going to let him make a play to win the game for him. And I think on the defensive side of the football, they made an adjustment. We're at a benchmark point in this game. It's 10:47 to go in the fourth quarter. Bethune-Cookman trails by three. They're at their own 41-yard line as we get a look at Henry Vaughn, who's needing some assistance to get off the field. And we won't speculate on it, but think about it. Florida A&M has been so successful on a couple of clutch fourth down conversions in Bethune-Cookman territory. Can Alvin Wyatt find a play with this break in the action that will get him about 15 yards and keep the drive moving? I mean, this is a real watershed moment right here, in my opinion, because Billy Joe needs to keep a drive going in the third quarter on a third and like 18, and he got it. Can Alvin Wyatt's team do the same?
Well, both bands treated us to a special show at halftime, the Battle of the Bands. And if you'd like to relive it or missed it and are sorry, no need to worry. 888-MR-VIDEO, and you can pick up a copy for as low as $30.
Well, if you look at the Florida A&M defense right now, you see a whole lot of clean jerseys. That means that there are a lot of guys that are coming in to fill the voids that were left by players who've been injured. Got to get some of those dirty jerseys healthy.
Zach Adrian punting away. Line drive will make it into the end zone for a touchback. Adrian, by the way, is in the game because Danny Mathis was hurt earlier. Mathis, a fine all-star field goal kicker, and was punting and was injured. Injured his ankle in the first half, has not returned. So Adrian, who originally was the punter when the season began, is now taking care of the duties tonight.
He's also handling the place kicking duties as well. And boy, how big could that be down the stretch?
First and 10 for Florida A&M. 20-yard line with a three-point advantage. And they keep it on the ground to the man who has over 100 yards rushing, and he punishes everyone that tries to tackle him. You can just ask Jimmy Williams, who got in the way on that one.
Yeah, man, when this kid turns the corner and he's got his speed, as you can see, Jimmy Williams, number 48 there, is worse off for wear after coming up and trying to take out Kelsey Lourdes. But it's just indicative of a defensive unit that's been on the field for the great portion of the second half. It seems like Florida A&M's offense has had the ball almost the entire second half, and the Bethune-Cookman defense has been wearing down ever since the FAMU defense came out after halftime.
As Williams has tended to, we'll take a look and see if we can figure out exactly what happened.
Boy, he just took a shoulder to the chest. Look at, whoo!
Got, boy. And the referee went up against Micah Simmons. You are watching Sunshine Network coverage of the Florida Classic. Mark Gray and Dwayne Ballin and 70,000 of our closest friends watching Bethune-Cookman and Florida A&M battle for the Mideastern Athletic Conference Championship and bragging rights in the state of Florida.
And it should be noted that the bragging rights are probably a lot more important in these parts than is the championship. I mean, it's nice to get a ring and a wonderful trophy to add to the case, but you want to be able to talk a little smack when you go to Daytona Beach if you're a Rattler, and if you come to Tallahassee if you're a Wildcat. Can't do that unless your team gets a W.
Second and one from the 29. Kelsey Lourdes, well, what do you know? Bethune-Cookman found a way to slow him down in the person of Steve Baggs.
Boy, and this is Alvin Wyatt, who's got to love. He's got to love Steve Baggs playing off his block to make that play. And there's a guy that would love to have bragging rights.
On third down, four. Full backfield for Florida A&M. And they give it to Marchbanks. William Hudson is there.
Well, he's going to be short. And it's an interesting play call for Billy Joe. It's a fourth down. And they're going to roll the dice here.
Folks, fourth and one at their own 29-yard line. And the Rattlers, trailing by just three with 8:58 to go, appear to be going for it. And they get it. O.J. Marchbanks pulls his way ahead for the first down with Micah Simmons hanging on. But that was a gutsy call by Coach Billy Joe.
Well, I think he senses the fact that his offensive line has worn down the defense in front of Bethune. They get great surge that time at the point of attack. And if you look at it, it's continuing behind Lamar Demps and Kenneth Jones.
And now it's Lordius behind that great offensive line with a huge pickup. Rasheen Mathis saving the day.
Well, I tell you, right up the gut. And Lordius is probably worn out from carrying the ball so much right now.
Lordius may very well be hurt, Mark, unless that's a cramp.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. It's a fatigued young fella right now.
Lordius, as we mentioned, is well over the 100-yard mark.
Watch him finding his hole, a lot of presence. Look at that trap action right up the middle. It's McCullough and Jones. Check that. It's McCullough and Terry Logan who open up that hole. And Florida A&M with a bit of a makeshift offensive line performing extremely well. And that's why Kelsey Lordius is rushed for 165 yards. A great job by there. Tremendous offensive line.
On first down, it's Gray for Steve Baggs gets a hold of him, the quarterback.
You see, you got the quarterback with the dirty jersey in there now. So you can see that he's going to get behind a couple of clean jerseys in the offensive front, pick up his first down. Big Nasties don't normally come out with clean jerseys.
Florida A&M now into Bethune-Cookman territory, looking for more than its three-point advantage. Out of the shotgun, their record-setting quarterback, Quinn Gray, off to O.J. Marchbanks, who runs into Anthony Hubbard, but not before another sizable gain.
Well, this is a great strategy right now. This is just basically a situation where Florida A&M is saying, you can't stop us running the football, so we're going to stay and we're going to continue to pound on you right here. And they're doing a great job.
And that brings up second and one. Ideal situation to be in at the 29-yard line. The surge from the offensive line gets the first down for Florida A&M.
That's almost unfair what Coach Joe did in that particular set. He had big Lamar Demps as a lead blocker in the backfield. Look at number 71 and number 61. Those are two big offensive linemen who line up in effectively the offensive backfield. And after the surge of the Big Nasties up front, those two guys protect Marchbanks, and he picks up another first down. Florida A&M's offensive line imposing their will on this game.
Gray avoids the sack and throws it away as his tight end Lutu was being defended by Micah Simmons.
Well, that may not go in the stat books as nothing more than an incomplete pass. Watch how big a play Quinn Gray makes as he escapes two defenders, the last being Steve Baggs, who leads the Wildcats in sacks, and he throws that pass away, keeps him in better field goal range.
It's second and 10. The middle through a hole is Lordius, and he's moving towards a 200-yard night.
Making it look easy. Just the discipline of following his lane and waiting for the hole to open, and he does a good job. See, look, he thought he was going up the middle, but he had to dance it just to the outside. He gave Rasheen Mathis a move back to the inside, and he has Hubbard and Heatley holding on for dear life, and that's what the Wildcats are doing right here, Dwayne. Holding on for their Florida Classic and their MEAC Championship lives here.
And now it's first and five. The MEAC's number one defense is being tested by the number one offense in the conference. Gray simply throws it away.
Boy, I'm telling you, there was nobody in the vicinity of that pass. We've seen a lot less called intentional grounding during the course of the season. Gray dodges a bullet that time. And see, now Florida A&M beginning to situate substitute linemen. They got Logan and Dempsey once again effectively.
Look in that backfield, two offensive linemen leading the way.
That's Terry Logan and Lamar Dempsey that are lining up in the offensive backfield, and you add them following the surge initially of the front, and that's why March Banks and Lordius are basically having their way. And there's Billy Joe trying to direct some traffic from up in his booth. He can smell it right now. Yo, look at him. This is a guy who's never done worse than second place in the MEAC since he took over the Rattler program 6 years ago.
Has six straight winning seasons. And his Rattlers are knocking on the door, third and goal.
They can smell it.
And Gray couldn't quite get there. Rasheen Mathis, Jimmy Williams, and Anthony Hubbard converging at the quarterback.
Well, watch right here. It's a little bit of that off-tackle stuff. And Mathis just makes a great one-on-one play. I think Bags forced it a little bit farther to the inside, and that allowed Williams to come up and make a tackle. And here we go.
There's some miscommunication now, so Florida A&M has called a timeout to discuss this.
Well, Quinn Gray and company are probably going to try to drive the final stake in the heart of Bethune-Cookman when we come back.
It's the Sunday Night Journey on Sunshine. Ease on in.
Think you've got college football covered? Think again. Now you can get up to 12 additional games each week with the ESPN Game Plan College Football Package, available on Dish On Demand pay-per-view. The best games, the major conferences, it's maximum college football. But you can't just tune in, you've got to order the ESPN Game Plan College Football pay-per-view package. To order, call 1-877-DISH-PPV.
Dish Network is all about convenience, and that means your bill, too. Try credit card auto pay. You can set up a credit card or debit card to pay your Dish Network bill automatically, and it's easy to sign up. Just check the auto payment box on the front of your bill and fill out the back. Send it to us with your payment, and next month your bill is paid on time, without writing a check or hassling with stamps and late fees. It's credit card auto pay from Dish Network.
Getting enough football? Good! Get in the game with all your favorite Florida teams at sunshinenetwork.com.
Quinn Gray and the Florida A&M Rattlers are 5 minutes and 34 seconds away from a Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference championship. They are 3 yards away, 1 yard away from another touchdown. And there it is. O.J. Marchbanks.
Well, Dwayne, Billy Joe told us that he thought the key to this game would be running the football. And when all was said and done, Quinn Gray relied on the surge and the power of his massive offensive front and the effectiveness of O.J. Marchbanks and Kelsey Lordius to really seize command of the classic. I mean, that, my friends, was an impressive drive, especially by the big nasties up front who just imposed their will on this game.
Vasquez on for the extra point.
Watch it again, a tight formation. Once again, Dempsey and Logan are in the backfield, and you see, they just follow the big guys up front, and there's Billy Joe going, yeah, baby, another ring. My friends, we're closer to another ring.
Thank you, Minister Gray. 31-21 now, Florida A&M, thanks to the March Banks touchdown, leads by 10. in the Florida Classic here in Orlando, Florida. Capacity crowd of over 70,000 cheering on what has been an exciting seesaw battle between these two arch rivals in the Sunshine State. You're watching it on the Sunshine Network, and it's been a fun game to do.
This is the first time in goodness knows how long that Florida A&M rolled into the Florida Classic not being ranked in the Division I AA polls. They had fallen to number 9 in the Sheridan Black College polls. And when all is said and done, you know, there were many experts around the country who figured that this was the time, a down year for Florida A&M, just a little bit, you know, not as much talent as you're normally accustomed to see wearing orange and green. Many experts that I talked to thought that this was the year that Bethune-Cookman, if they were going to ever get Florida A&M, this was the best time. And folks, Florida A&M has stepped up once again, and you can just get the feeling that the great big rattler in the sky named Jake Gaither was working it out.
Norman Graham on the return for Bethune-Cookman. James Dawkins making the stop. So now the Wildcats face a 10-point deficit with 5:18 to go. And a Florida A&M defense that might be a bit rejuvenated despite some injuries this evening.
Well, Alan Suber is a master of improvisation. He's got 4-4 speed. He's got a big-time arm. He's an accurate passer. It will take all of his skills to lead the Cats back.
Out of the shotgun, Suber with the time to throw. Has a receiver, Tarion Hubbard, across the middle. And it's Troy Hart defensively.
And one thing about it, when Bethune-Cookman breaks the bone, they are not in awe of any situation. Zuber can pass with the best passes in all of 1AA. And I think that, as we saw against Delaware State early in the season, if they have to rely on him to go to the air, this offense is none the worse for wear.
That 15-yard pickup sets up first down at the 35-yard line. Suber again on the air, has a receiver across the middle and has plenty of room to run. Eric Lash.
Suber.
Levy Brown again on the tackle.
Well, this is just an opportunity for him to sit in the pocket out of the shotgun and wait for his receiver to make his break across the middle. And this is Lash, so dangerous, running with the football after the catch, finding the soft area in the center of the FAMU defense. And he's able to pick up big chunks of yardage and move the ball into FAMU territory.
Sunshine Network gives you behind-the-scenes access to the Miami Dolphins Monday night at 9:30 during Miami Dolphins Magazine. Host James Bates provides exclusive interviews and in-depth features with the coaches and players. Miami Dolphins Magazine, Monday night at 9:30 only on Sunshine Network. Alvin Wyatt's Bethune-Cookman Wildcats down by 10 with 4:43 to go in the Florida Classic.
And this one ain't over yet. I mean, we've seen some strange occurrences in the MEAC this season. Bethune-Cookman, as Carlton Moore lathers his defensive unit. But I tell you something, you look at Suber, he's only thrown the ball 13 times. Still, he's outpassed Quinn Gray in terms of yardage and with two scores, no INTs. But the burden of proof clearly falls on his shoulder right now, and that of Alvin Wyatt.
Alvin Wyatt looks like a very worried man.
Well, down by 10 with 4:43 to go in the fourth quarter, I think you'd be having feelings of trepidation too, my friend.
First and 10 from the 46 of Florida A&M for Bethune-Cookman. Suber is being chased and dropped by Sean Kelly. His 11th sack of the season.
That time Suber held the ball too long. He had Henry out in the flat. And you see, watch. Ample time to survey some things. That's Henry out there wide open at the off to the right of your screen. And him holding the football allows Kelly to track him down from the backside and get his 11th sack of the season.
So it's second and 12. Suber in trouble again. Gets it away, has a receiver. It's Eric Lash, who was fighting with Carlos Moore for yardage.
Suber doing a solid job, getting out the outside the pocket, buying himself some time to make a play. But Bethune-Cookman, as you watch Alan Suber right here, just calm under pressure. He knows they're looking for him, and look at that battle. Sean Kelly plays off the block. Nice running pass that time by Alan Suber. Boy, he can really thread the needle on the run.
12-yard pickup sets up third and two. Suber is intercepted by Troy Hart.
This could be big.
And Hart returns it just over the 45-yard line. His fourth interception of the season.
So now Hart steps into a tie with Levy Brown for the top spot on the interception list at Florida A&M. He told me in the hotel yesterday he was going to get him one. Troy Hart, you the man. Backing up, just playing out there. You know, he's the underneath man, and it looks like a three-deep zone. He jumps off the coverage and hauls in that pass. And that, my friends, could just about seal Bethune-Cookman's fate.
Did you notice the running back coming out in him there? He's directing traffic.
Exactly. So Troy Hart, who's in the midst of a brilliant career, this young fella is, what a way to cap your season with a huge interception.
So the Rattlers take over, and this man continues to go to work. Kelsey Lordius, who before that carry, has a new personal best, 181 yards in this game and 24 carries. Before that, his best game was 121 yards on 17 carries against Delta State last season.
Delaware.
Now he is at 183, Delaware State.
Got Delta on your mind, huh? Anyway, this is Kelsey Lordius just running between the tacklers, getting to the outside, playing physical against Bethune-Cookman's defense. And this, that's a fantastic performance.
Second and eight. And Lordius, who just seems to have another gear, just will not stop. He gets up slowly, but that lulls the defense to sleep. And he comes back banging and ramming again.
Look at the footwork. Dance in, dance out, you know, find another gear, sprint to the hole, get through there. And by then he's got enough speed so that when you come up and try to tackle him, as there was a big tackle earlier in there on him, and I think Jimmy Williams was the one who was none the worse, well, who suffered for it.
It's third and five from midfield. Quinn Gray, a shovel pass. And this one to Lordius, but Steve Baggs had a bead on it. Hope you've been enjoying the Florida Classic on the Sunshine Network, sponsored by Walt Disney World Resort. Executive producer of Sunshine Network, Chris Glass. Tonight's producer, Major Howe. Director, Anthony Earle. Technical director, Mike Lacey. Stage manager, Tracy Morris. Facilities provided by Northwest Mobile Television.
Well, Florida A&M will go back to familiar territory. They'll get a week off, try to heal some wounds, and it'll be off to the 1AA playoffs. We have no idea where the Rattlers will go, but congratulations to Billy Joe, Jimmy Joe, Clifton Moore, and the entire Rattler staff, athletic director Ken Riley. And for the record, the greatest travesty in the Pro Football Hall of Fame is that Ken Riley, the athletic director of FAMU, is not in the Hall of Fame. I mean, if this were different times, you talk about going postal, but I don't think that's apropos. But correct the wrong that is due, and let us get Ken Riley into the Hall of Fame. And, of course, Alvin Wyatt, who's certainly destined for Bethune-Cookman's Hall of Fame, will have to go back to the drawing board for 12 more months and wonder again what may have been.
His Wildcats will drop to 5-3 in the conference, 6-4 overall, while Florida A&M will go to 7-1 and win the Mideastern Athletic Conference and go to 7-3 overall.
So Quinn Gray will have three rings. You know, this is a guy who really has been appreciated in Tallahassee a great deal. And there's a guy in Billy Joe. Well, if he continues to enjoy the kind of success that he enjoyed for a little less than a decade, they'll be naming the field at Bragg Stadium in Tallahassee after Billy Joe. It'll be Bragg Stadium, home of Billy Joe Field. Because this guy has never done less than second place since he's been at FAMU. And now he gets his second straight bling bling. Congratulations to the Rattlers, champions of the MEAC for 2001.
An emotional victory for Florida A&M, the 500th school victory. Earlier this season, reports of their demise were greatly exaggerated.
Only two historically black colleges can boast of eclipsing that 500 win mark, Tuskegee and Florida A&M. What do they both have in common? Coach Rick Comagie at Tuskegee was a coordinator for Billy Joe when he was at Central State, so there is some synergy there.
The Florida Classic goes to Florida A&M, 31-21 here in Orlando. Back to wrap things up after these messages.
I am Ruth Riley. My life revolves around sports. I love to watch sports, to play sports. My favorite movie is Hoosiers. It's not a top choice. The best movie ever made. My mom means everything to me, and my family has been so supportive of me along the way. I do try to answer all my family. If people take the time to write to me, that's the least I can do is take the time to write them back.
For Miami Soul tickets, call 786-777-4SOL or log on to MiamiSoul.com.
Fishing then? Fishing now. As the needs of the avid angler have changed, so has Pfluger, the legendary tackle manufacturer. Pfluger is setting a new standard in quality and performance with the Tryon series. Tryon spinning reels, Tryon bait casting reels, and Tryon graphite rods. Fishing has changed, but you can still rely on Pfluger, a fishing tradition for over 120 years. Isn't it time you experience the legendary feel of a Pfluger?
We've always gone our own way in the South. How we drive, where we drive, what we drive. The kind of cars, the kind of trucks. Like this Dodge Ram Quad Cab. The only full-size pickup with four real doors and a full-size bed. Plus the biggest brakes and wheels in its class. You'll find it down the road a piece at Truckville. Known in these parts as your New South Dodge dealer.
Let those lost weekend blues get you down when your weekend is all said and done. What you really need is a little Sunday Night Journey. We'll lure you into a solid block of outdoor programming with tips from some of the best experts on hunting and fishing. So kick back, get comfortable, and ease on in for a Sunday Night Journey on Sunshine. Feel the impact. Feel the power. It's in the attitude, the adrenaline rush, the overloaded punch. So get ready to rumble. Boxing on Sunshine. Are you feeling it? Striking up the best of the best. Bringing on a new sensation in boxing. And it's all right here. Boxing on Sunshine. Are you feeling it?
Welcome back to Orlando, the Florida Citrus Bowl, and the Florida Classic goes to Florida A&M. This was a game where we couldn't get a sense of what was going to happen, really until the last few minutes of the fourth.
Well, this was a situation where Billy Joe told us coming in that the key to this game was going to be running the football. Look at the outstanding performances by that big offensive line of Florida A&M. Super performance by Kelsey Lourdes, and give Quinn Gray credit for masterfully directing this new Florida A&M offense. I tell you what, I wouldn't want to have to game plan against an effective running Florida A&M Rattler team if I've got to face them in the 1AA playoffs.
Not only do the Rattlers earn the Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference championship again, but now they head into the postseason, something that a short while ago did not look possible.
Well, Dwayne, this is the Florida A&M team that, unlike last year, they get a week off to get ready for the 1AA playoff. That means they get an extra week to prepare, get some folks healthy. and they should be all right. But nothing is going to touch the Florida Classic. This is truly an amazing event.
Offensive MVP for Bethune-Cookman, Alan Suber. Defensively, Rasheen Mathis for Florida A&M, Kelsey Lourdes, and Nakia Bynum. Game most valuable player, Kelsey Lourdes, with that career night. Nextel Florida Sports News, weeknights at 10 p.m. It provides you with everything you need to know about Florida sports. For Mark Gray and our entire Sunshine Network crew, congratulations to Florida A&M, champions of the Florida Classic. Good night from Orlando.
Entertainment Mecca, the city of Orlando. It's a battle of the bands like no other. More than 70,000 fans joining you in the Citrus Bowl for an encore presentation of the Marching Wildcat from Bethune-Cookman College and the Marching 100 of Florida A&M. The sounds and sensations from Central Florida just ahead.
Where Bethune-Cookman leads 14-9 at halftime. Now, for something that's just as much a part of this event as the game itself, we begin with the bands. First, the Florida A&M Marching 100 will electrify you with the
event. And now we dedicate these halftime performances to you.
Alvin Benton, Antonio Drayton, Virgil Miller, Morris Martin, Jamar Bundridge, Corey Lynch. Together they are the eight wonders of the world, setting the standards for drum majors all over the world and even here.
Come on.
All aboard.
High step toward more of the Marching 100 of Florida A&M on Sunshine Network. We'll frame our gridiron stage for more of the world-renowned Marching 100 of Florida A&M.
University is very pleased to present to Dr. James W. Chief Wilson, retired director of Jones High School, recently inducted into the Florida Bandmasters Hall of Fame. Along with his wife, Virginia, he's been presented this plaque from Dr. Jeannie White, Director of Bands and Chairman of the Department of Music at Florida A&M University. Congratulations, Chiefs. Pause in the huge sculptured concert band formation. With the top of the hands of Dr. Jeannie White, Director of Bands, please enjoy a beautiful arrangement from Lindsay Sargent. The Osley Brothers, Contagious.
Thank you.
of excellence and standards for the world. Nobody does it better. It's time. In case you didn't know, she got it from her mama. We can't leave like this. What we're gonna do here now is show out. nowhere. Just got a call from Orlando International Airport. And the arrival of Petey Pablo is now out there with the 100. It's time. Bands. Lindsay B. Sargent, Assistant Director of Bands. Shelby Chipman, Assistant to the Director. Mrs. Deneen White, Director of the Piccolos. Mr. Wallace Clark, Director of the Clarinets. Mr. Longinu Parchin, Director of the Trumpets. And Donna Beckwith, Equipment Manager.
Take your shirt off!
Timothy Barber, Delano Dean, Carl Lynch, Alvin Benton, Antonio Drayton, Virgin Miller, Jabbar Bondridge. Ladies and gentlemen, the voice of the 100 has been Joe Bullard.
The Florida A&M Marching 100 thrilling the crowd at the Florida Classic with an electrifying halftime show. There is much more to come. The Marching Wildcats from Bethune-Cookman take center stage when we return.
Rugged.
Well, if you are interested in ordering a video of the Battle of the Bands, the halftime show, 888 Mr. Video. Prices start at $30. For more of this show, now the Bethune-Cookman Marching Wildcats and their halftime presentation.
You tried to show out, but now, sit down, take notes, pay attention, and remember the rules. This is the only band in the world that's guaranteed to show up and show out on any band, any day, anytime, anywhere. And 100, it's your turn. In Rattler blood. 100, you are the weakest link.
entertainment from the Marching Wildcats of Bethune-Cookman College on Sunshine Network. Bethune-Cookman College, offering a dazzling array of bright smiles and beautiful music at the Citrus Bowl.
Undeniably incredible, and you know it, the 14 Karat Gold Dancers. In the days of yesteryear, when radio had it going on, you fell in love to the OJs, and right now, Rattlers, Wildcats, and everything else in between, let's climb the stairway to heaven. Just wish I had somebody to testify. OJ, 2020 flashbacks, climbing the stairway to heaven. Directed by Mr. Donovan Wells. Arranged by James Portier, assistant director and arranger. Thank you. to break it down and show out on the 100. But wait a minute. Now, go ahead and do it. 100 base in your face. Handle it if you can. Every rattler in the house, this is for you. Just stomp one or two. Wildcats, it's your turn. Now, let's close the show. Marching Wildcats of Bethune-Cookman College under the direction of Mr. Donovan Wells.
Just ahead, bonus coverage of football, the conclusion of the Florida Classic, the Cats and the Rattlers on Sunshine.